And we are live, me and Steve Rush. Hello, everybody out there.
Hey now, welcome to our world.
Our little private world that we don't let anybody in. We really don't. We call it the Steve and Debi world.
And it's a good world. You know, it's just like the months we were talking about yesterday. Yeah, like we had relationships with months. We did. And
so many
it's all about July.
So many people thought that April was a female, and it's not. It's Alan Prill. It's April. And I slept with that guy for months and then dumped him like a bad habit.
Wait, how did you sleep with a month for months?
Like,
did you have con every...
Steve, you're so funny. I love
did
that.
Did you cheat with June and think it was April? Maybe you had some July in there?
Did you try to make funny with the goddesses joke, Steve? Huh?
I don't know. I told you I'm trying to save my material when I need it.
I hate Mother's Day. Why do I hate Mother's Day? It's like...
By the way, I must say Happy Mother's Day.
No, I don't want to have a Happy Mother's Day.
All right, you miserable cuss.
No, I told Jed, he goes, Mika, why don't... He came over today. I said, Heather, do me a favor. If you love me, bring me Jed. Because I like to live in the world of his amazing wonderment and non-corrupt brain. I fucking love that.
Absolutely true.
Fucking love that. He goes, Mika, do you really think that Superman would kill Batman? He's dead serious, Steve. Dead serious.
Right.
Said, you know something, Jet? I don't know. He might. He goes, are you serious? I said, well, Jet. He goes, Batman didn't kill Superman. He goes, Deadshot did. And I said, but Batman just stood there and watched. Because he goes, is he really coming back to the Justice League? And I said, he's coming back, but he's this real badass Superman. He's solid black and everything, and his suit is all made of black diamonds. He goes, I know, I saw it. Because I told you I had to carry Jed out of the theater when Superman died, right?
Yeah, I heard about that.
He had on his Superman outfit. I put my jacket on.
You've killed my young spirit.
He was crying. He was crying.
Imagine how good life is when that is your biggest concern.
Yeah.
What happens on a screen?
Well, it was Superman versus Batman. Remember the big deal last summer, the big blockbuster, and we camouflage. He was all excited. We went in, and Superman ends up fucking dying. I was like, oh my god. He was going. He goes, honey, listen to me.
Oh, God.
Oh, my God. It was horrible. Batman killed him.
He's walking out with a dead man's uniform.
Oh, yeah, Superman. He felt embarrassed. And this other little black kid we walked down, he had on a Batman outfit. And I said, if that little motherfucker looks over and flips off Jet, I'm going to hurt him, Vic. Like, fuck you. We kicked your ass. Superman did die.
Could you imagine you guys are leaving and Jet sees another little kid going into the theater to see the next showing?
He dies.
He was just like, man, don't do it.
Superman dies.
I don't want to tell you what happens, but just don't do it to yourself.
Oh my
don't
God.
Go see this.
But I swear to God, I was shoulder to shoulder going out the theater with a black man, a very nice, you know, nice black family, holding his, and he had the Batman outfit on, and Jay was kind of just recoiling real
you
little.
You mother.
So I put my jacket.
I saw what you did in there.
I put my jacket over him. I always wear a dinner jacket. Yeah, we call it a dinner jacket. You know, just a nice jacket when I go out over my jeans and everything. And I took it off, and I put it on Jay to cover up his Batman.
Cover the shame.
It was horrible. And so we played tennis today. And when what tennis is for Jet is I volley the ball over to him. And he goes, bam! And he just goes, and I have to go chase the ball.
A little hostility built up, you think? You know? No, just lost his hero.
Oh, he's great to play tennis with.
Kids are great because you know what? If you want the truth, ask him a question.
Yeah, exactly. Exactly. You know what he said to me the other day? There's a... Do you ever watch SpongeBob?
I loved SpongeBob. My son was a big fan when he was a little kid, and then I'm like, it was a secret excuse for me to watch it. So it was great to have kids.
Well, we were watching it the other day, and it had Patrick and everybody on there. And there's a little old, like a grandma lady. She's Mrs. Oh, fuck.
Yeah, I don't remember their names.
And he was laying on the couch, and he starts giggling. I go, what? He goes, I told Mommy that was makeup. I go, Jet? He was just losing it. He loves when I go, Jet? Because, and then the other day we were in the drugstore together, just buying shampoos and stuff like that. And I go, Jet, or I forgot what we were doing. Anyway, but that's what I spent my day with. And that's what I love is being.
Well, that's, what you know? More could you ask for then? I got to spend time with my grandbabies, and it was good. And my kids, it was just a good day. And I'm a father, so I was enjoying the day with them, even though it wasn't Father's Day.
So. I like July.
I like July.
That was so fucking funny.
I think that the things that we do that people like enjoy and that we look back and enjoy are the things that we never know are coming, that are completely spontaneous.
I have to tell
no
you.
No preparation.
Me and Jewish producer have been brainstorming our new up and coming thing, whatever you want to call it. And I have got to tell you some of the things we've got in store for you. Davy Jones reviews. Wait a minute. Rating songs 1 to 10 tambourines, dating advice with Aunt B.
Oh, I like that.
Dating about Johnny T. Stuck in the grease days. Boy in the bubble gives advice since he's never been exposed. This is what Jewish Trisha wrote. Since he's never
that's
been exposed.
Really good Tyrone, ideas.
And then Jewish Trisha wrote Tyrone gives relationship advice, and I put Steve feed you the questions. Dear Tyrone, dear Mr. Shoelace, but he always recommends just popping a cap in a bitch.
Right.
Steve is an old 80s drummer. Let's see. Mr.
Well, that part's just true.
On the couch with JP, who is the craziest, the worst psychologist, and he always just tells people just to give up.
Yeah, you're going to die anyway.
And I'm going to do a song that goes, if you're blue and you don't know what to do, you can call JP and he will say, give up, man. I mean,
give up anyway.
Fuck it. And then it says, hello, Debi, with Mr. Minot movie. Debi doesn't realize that her looks have faded. Mr. Minot movie goes, lady, but he says daily. Anyway, And then we're always, let's see, the angry bong, when asked about women, always takes a bong rip and just says, bitches be tripping. Even if it's about his mother or his new baby daughter that he didn't know, he just says, bitches be tripping. What is that?
That's my pager going off. Sorry.
My daughter. Hold on.
Oh, that is my pager.
Hello?
From 82.
Hey.
What's wrong?
What are you doing right now?
I'm fixing to go on the air.
Is Dad around you or anything?
Take over, Steve.
Yeah. Am I muted? I guess she muted me. Or herself. There we go. Let's do the early shout out for the chat room. By the way, Steve Rush is in the chat room, which is just awesome. That dude. Fucking interesting. Stabby McCuggs, what's up, brother? Eric, how you doing, brother? Good to see you. Appreciate the comment you left. Darren, how are you? Apocalypse, ACOG, always good to see all you guys. Happy Sunday. Happy Mother's Day to all of you. there's a way, like when I was married, one of those times where I figured out a way to make Mother's Day work for me. Like I would have the kids want to go places that I wanted to go. How terrible is that? Like, I'd be like, I want to go do this. Tell Mommy that's what you want to do. Okay, Dad. That was smart. Manipulation, yes, but smart. But, yeah, it's good to see you guys. I wasn't going to do a show tonight. I'm like, man, I'm really tired. Been running around like a maniac. But it's good to come out here. It's good to be part of this. This is as crazy as it gets and as awkward as it could be at times. It's a good time, and you leave I usually leave with a positive thought or a very pissed off thought, but either way I leave. So, but I enjoy being part of it. Look at all these hugs. You got all these hugs in the chat room. Jesus, it's a hug fest. No reach arounds, guys. Come on. It's Mother's Day. For the sake of all that is good. Just straight up hugs. So. Debi got it. She's on an important conference call, so we'll stand by quietly. And I have no board, so what could I play? You just heard it. Nothing.
I'm coming right back. Hold on, guys.
See, now I feel safe again. I don't mind. No, I really don't mind being on the air by myself. I've done it. I do it when I do my own show. I'm good with it. But it's weird because you have your controls, so you could do what you want to do. You could play bits or bytes and have people call in. It's kind of cool. Here I'm like on an island. waiting for a ship to pass for ideas. That's where the chat rooms comes in. Sing us a song. That ain't going to happen. Sorry, Darren.
Damn it. Darren. I just hung up on Heather. I'm like, I've had enough. Go away.
She might be calling back.
Not let her call back. I won't answer. There's a rift going on between her and Vic, and I'm just like, don't get me in the middle of your crap. That's not my deal. I deal with my stuff, okay? They've got this big war going, and I'm not doing it. I'm not going to go.
I agree.
I don't believe that people should call and wear people out. Well, Steve, you know, Stabby this and Stabby that. Go to Stabby, Debbie. Go to the person that you have the problem with, and this is what I tried to do to Dennis that time. I said, don't get in the middle of it. Don't side with people in arguments, because if they were, I'm not going to side with Heather. I'm not going to side with Vic, because if they work it out, then I look stupid. I love you, Hank. There, you know, so I'm just, that's y'all's deal. I wasn't there. I don't know the feelings. I don't feel the passions that you feel in this. So don't get me involved in your stuff. I'm really a pretty cool person if you knew me. I mean, I'm really not what people have tried to paint me out to be, which is psycho evil bitch.
That was really well said, by the way. When you listen back to that, that was nailing it.
It's just the truth.
I like that.
Truth. Listen to me, Stephen. If you were having a huge argument with, say, Dennis, you'd be like, God damn, I'd say, Steve, I really don't want this. I mean, nothing personal, but, you know.
Well, you've always said in throughout the years that, listen, I don't get in the middle of two men fighting. I don't want to be in the middle of your fight.
That's because the internet's men. That's all the internet is. It's 99% men. So it's just basically, it's a man's world, which I intend on conquering. No, I'm joking. But, I'm kidding, of course. But, you know, the thing about it is,
I don't think you are.
I did this one time. I cited because Mr. Solution had pushed me beyond the brink with insulting my friend, Mr. Midnight Movie. Mm-hmm. And I lit into him, like my mom used to say, and I didn't let up until thunder struck. And I mean, I was just like, look, I'm nuts on him. And he came back. Yeah. It took a few months, but he came back with his hat in his hand, you know, but I usually don't do that.
Well, so. There are certain people out here that I would do that for. For instance, Dave Fiker, on two or three occasions, people have gone after him. He's one of those people that I would protect. Everybody else can handle themselves pretty much.
There's a fine line, Stephen, between white knighting and getting in between two other people.
Mm-hmm.
You know what I'm talking about? Do you really?
Of course I do. Of course I do. Yeah, I mean, you can't go too far with it, and it has to be something that you know something about, or just shut the hell up. If you don't have a horse in it, or dog in the fight, stay out of it.
Yep, and don't, because that was the only problem that I had with Darren. Because Darren, I was reading chat logs and stuff that were saying, hey man, it's Debbie. I heard Joe on Debbie's show. He was right. He was right. And I thought, don't do that, because see, Joe and I are going to make up, and then I'm going to know what you thought and what you think has no bearing on me and Joe. Does that make any fucking sense or something?
Yeah, it makes sense to me. I mean, it's you're better off doing it the way you're. Listen, anybody that comes to you and gives you advice on how to do this is an idiot. So you've lasted longer than anybody I've known. So I'm just saying, like you know what you're doing. You're safe. I don't worry about you.
Okay, see, that right there is what bums me out when you're giving me this compliment. You always say you've lasted longer. Well, an idiot can last. I mean, Cowpoke's still doing this. I would rather you say, anybody that comes and gives you advice is an idiot, because you've got this shit nailed. You always say you've lasted longer.
Let me write this down so I can say it the way you enjoy it.
7 second delay. Hold on.
Exactly. Debbie, you've lasted this long. No. I said what I said, and I'm not going to retract my statement. I think longevity means everything. Yeah, maybe Cowpoke has been doing it forever or whatever, but guess what? He hasn't been doing it well. He repeats everybody else's shit. He takes all of your dialogue. He takes all of your bits. He tries to get your people. That's not doing it the same way.
He's not the only one that does that.
There's many that have tried that. And that's just called staying afloat. That isn't floating.
You know
very
what?
Well.
I've got you holding on to so many of these bits. One of them's called Accepting Death with Davey.
Accepting Death? What happened?
Davy Jones accepting.
Oh.
Because Davy Jones doesn't realize he's dead, you know?
Yeah, he has no idea. Him and Harry Carey party all the time. Wearing, it's crazy.
We're wearing Johnny T out. I mean, Johnny T is.
Would you say that that's the best one? Or with the Arabic fucking, guy?
No, I can't. My ears start burning when you go into that Arabic guy. You love that guy. I can't stand that guy. Maybe that's just being racist or something, but when you do Johnny T, and the thing about it is when you develop a character for a show, and I learned this from Phil Hendry. You and I both did that night. We were both on the air. He says, mm-hmm. You don't do a voice. You develop the character, which, like I was talking about Blaine last night, I said, even in the case of Blaine, even when I'm listening to you and I, and we've got Blaine on there, there's parts of my brain that actually believe that's a guy named Blaine.
Absolutely.
You know what I'm saying? Because we know yes. And I'm going, oh my God.
When I'm doing Johnny T, listen, like, and I'm saying I have Aunt B that lives here, right? And when I'm doing that, like, it sounds, to you people that listen, it's going to sound crazy. I'm literally envisioning me pointing over to a bed or a couch that she would be on. So that way I can actually feel when I want to transfer her onto the microphone. Yeah, but when I transfer to the microphone, it sounds like an actual transfer.
Okay, like, wait. I want to sit on just a second. Hi, Steve.
You want to sit on me for a second? What was that?
A little cup of cream. listen to me. What do you mean, a voice? I am blind. Hey, Debi, do you see me out here in the shed? Fucking asshole bitch. What the fuck? I can't.
That is no language. Just that's Mother's Day. You don't say that. Say it tomorrow.
I hated my mother. My mother is why I'm gay.
You got to stop choking your chipoodle and just get over it.
Debi, would you put some more freaking bass on my voice? Thank you very much. Hi there, little. You know those little tiny cream cups of cream that you get when you get coffee to go with.
Oh yeah, those are awesome.
When I look at that, I think that's Steve. My baby. Do you think of me when you hit that cajoni, that cajoni? Do you?
My own.
You know, like banging.
I'm sorry, that just cracked me up.
I'm serious. Do you ever fall off that motherfucker when you lean back? I'm sorry, Steve.
Only one time.
I'm sorry. You actually fell. Please, wait a minute. Stop. Don't be lying.
I'm crying right now.
I swear to God, you actually.
Oh my
sometimes
God!
Sometimes you tilt
little
back
cups
a little.
Of creamer. Oh my God! And I'm picturing these little plastic cups of creamer to peel off the top.
And
I'm
your,
like, oh my God!
Your face is on him when he opens it up. And he sees your.
Oh my
God! Hi, Blaine.
Hi, Blaine. My dairiness.
Oh my God!
Oh my God! Literally, I'm crying. I'm not even lying, man. I'm
watering.
Wait,
let's go back to you fell off to Cajon. You actually?
No, almost. I was I was in the middle of a tune. And I play double bass.
Please God.
On a real drum set. So I double kick sometimes. If you look at the videos, you'll see that I'm kicking sometimes. One time I kicked a little too aggressively. And my hand is hitting the middle of the drum as hard as I can. So it's like pushing it too. So I'm like, the fuck am I trying to do? Kill myself here? Do I need insurance to play the cajon?
That was good stuff. I heard 25 or 6 till 4. Not bad. It's pretty good. That's a hard one.
It's a freaking impossible song to play. That is like an all-out just bombardment of percussion. You got to remember they have a drummer who's rated A, and then they've got a whole rhythm section. So that's why it sounds so damn full. Because you got other instruments playing along with it.
What do you mean a whole other rhythm section?
I'll bet you on 26 or 94. I bet you that there's a cajon on that song.
Stop. What did you call the name of the song?
25 or 6 to 4.
I love you. Thank you.
Why did I say? Did I miss it?
You go 29 or 5 or 4.
25, 9 or 4. Adam 16. 25 or 6 to 4, dickhead. Over.
I love that song. It's so sad though, because you know why 25 or 64 breaks my heart? Why? Because I have all the bass turned off of me too. What the fuck, Deborah?
I have none.
Wait a minute. Okay, wait. Here I am. Wait a minute. What's going on with me, Deb? I don't know. Well, anyway, wait a minute. What happened here? What about
It's Blaine's fault.
Let me speak like the goddess from the mountaintop. When I hear 25 or 6 to 4, which was obviously composed and everything was Terry Kath, it breaks my heart, Steve, because I think that that was the time that he got killed. He was up all night with his the one that goes, what's that called, a trombone?
I believe it is a trombone.
Did you say Goddess, may I? I'm joking, Steve.
Goddess, may I answer you? I believe it was a trombone.
And he was sitting there with him, and they have this entire story online, and he said, there's nothing in it. He goes, what do you think I'm going to do, blow my head off? And he puts it up to his side of his head and pulls the trigger. And the guy just said, I don't believe that just happened, because he said all he did was he was sitting. He had this, you know, those seats that are in like a booth at a malt shop or something where Johnny T would mm-hmm. go. Okay. He had two of those pushed together, and behind it, right behind where his neck was, there was a shelf. And he said he just went doink and just put his head back.
Well, that's
I know.
Not a good way to go out.
But, well, yeah, not a good way to go out. But wasn't it true that there was not a round in the chamber? It was a blank, right, that went through?
I don't remember the whole story.
I heard that.
I remember that he blew his head off.
But he didn't.
Joking around with Russian roulette.
Yeah, and it was a complete accident. Now, see, if my little brother, and this is what the people in the inquest said, the reason they thought that my brother shot him because of the way it went, you know, because anybody mm-hmm. that commits suicide puts the trigger, either puts the gun in their mouth or they put it to their temple, you know, or whatever. And this was not that way. And so they had an inquest, but that's why I've always maintained, you know, if my brother, I don't even know what I was going to say. Forget that idea. But
I've been doing that a lot lately.
I know, me too.
I'm running down an avenue. I'm like, I got this idea. I'm talking about it. And all of a sudden, what the fuck was I just talking about?
Oh,
hold on. I think it was interesting.
Let me tell you what's fucked up is don't ever go running with Jet. What the fuck? I was like, Jet, stop. I'm not kidding. Stop. I said, I'm not kidding. He was going. He sprints. He'll go, ready? Go. He'll go. And he's really fast. And I'm like going, Jet, stop. And he was just cute.
That's awesome.
He's fixing to leave for the summer.
Well, see, you don't need to think about that. But
I know,
you think about the good stuff. Think about the good stuff.
I'm not.
It's me and you. Keep the tempo up high. Wee. Hello.
Okay.
And she just was breathing.
I breathed.
Good.
I breathed.
Awesome. Proud of you.
Have I shown you Stabby's new commercial that I'm going to do for the show?
I would like to know that. I would love to see it.
It's called Wells for Boys. I thought it was like Wellesley for Boys because Wellesley's an all-girls school. So that's the only reason why I clicked on that. What is Wells for Boys? And I thought, oh, there he is again. My little cupcake. My little reason for breathing. My love. My little love muffin. My little potato.
How do you really feel? Yeah.
My little painted face potato chip.
Painted face potato chip. You won't hear that anywhere else tonight. Promise
you. I actually would like to kill Stabby, and that bothers me. You know, are you sick?
Sorry. No. I just water down the wrong pipe or some shit.
Okay, watch. You ready to hear? We're gonna do a thing with you. Okay, you ready? We're gonna do your 25 or 6 to 4 in a minute. But first, I want to show you. Watch your screen, Steve. Ready? Mm-hmm. Here's Stabby's new up and coming commercial. Please play.
With Fisher-Price playsets, some kids can be four-star chefs. Some kids can win the race. But some just long to be understood. Introducing Wells for Sensitive Little Boys from Fisher-Price. Wells for sensitive boys to wish upon, confide in, and reflect by. Some boys live unexamined lives, but this one's heart is full of questions. Just hear how much he loves the well.
You don't want to do the commercial anymore? Okay. Do you want to go watch E2 Mama Tambien? Yeah? Okay, he wants to go back to the well.
He'll enjoy running his little fingers around the edge of the well. On days when he's had too much, he'll lean on it and contemplate his reflection. Some kids like to play. Others just sort of wait for adulthood.
Look at his dad.
So what is he putting in there?
A secret.
He'll grow up to have a wildly passionate and successful creative life, but not just yet.
Hey, Spencer! Spencer! Spencer!
Spencer.
Yes, Mom. Also, check out other cool new toys for our sensitive boy line, like balconies for when they're ready to announce something, or a shattered mirror to examine the complex contradictions of their being.
My God.
Is this not hysterical?
This is depressing.
I'm telling you something. Tina Fey is heading up the writing department right now of SNL, and it's off the frickin' chain, Steve. I mean,
it is, but it's only off the chain because of political reasons. It's come back.
Oh,
thank God for Trump.
Trump picked
them up, man.
I disagree. I think that Leslie Jones is knocking it out of the ballpark with the young boy. His last name is the cute guy that plays golf. Oh, fuck, what's his name? I mean, she is off the chain with him. Leslie Jones has become my comedic hero lately. That's where I get you little cup of cream. And that's what
she
always does that.
I'm not crazy about her at all.
Oh,
she annoys me on some level, and I don't know why.
I think
she tries to be too butch, and then she tries to be too – she thinks she's sexy. And
well,
it's like,
she's
please.
Gay. She's gay. She's a lesbian in real life, so that, you know, should answer some questions.
Yeah, I didn't know that. But
yeah.
Tina Fey's phenomenal. I think she's a brilliant lady. She writes incredible.
Mm-hmm.
She's a great actress. I think she's fantastic. And she's really attractive, which is a plus, you know?
That's what I get all the time. I get sick of that. It's a curse.
Well, you know, you ladies have to live with that.
Heather asked me the other day, she goes, Mom, what is it about our looks? Nobody ever takes us fucking serious. I hate that shit. And I said, well, just... Oh, he's so funny. And this young kid right here, I haven't figured out what his name is because I never get his name. I think that to hang out with this kid in real life would be absolutely one of the amazing things. I think he would probably be absolutely making you crack up every 10 minutes. I don't know why.
I just see
that in that kid. Tina Fey came on not too long ago and looked 6.3 million and did Meet Your Second Wife. She wrote that.
Mm-hmm.
And that is so funny, you know? I mean, it's just crazy. I'm so into comedy.
I'm so into her. I think she's just really, really good. She's just very believable. I dig her a lot. Always did.
You know
she's
what?
Not, the thing is, like, she's not a sex goddess, but yet she's attractive. She's the girl next door, and she's witty, and she gets it, and she's fun. And, that would be a great person to date. Wow.
Heather said something really weird yesterday in front of Philip and his parents and stuff like that. And they were talking and they said, oh, yeah, we listen to your show sometimes. It's really funny. And his father goes, what we love is Debi breaking character. And I went, am I missing something here? You know, in my mind, I went, oh, I laughed along, but I thought, what the fuck does he mean? And I think what he meant is I don't know. The way I laugh so much, even when I'm trying to tell something and I can't get it out, I just start laughing, you know? I guess that's what he means by break. So I went on the web and I started looking at breaking character today.
Mm-hmm, right.
And it's true that there are people that can't do – I could never do that kind of comedy. I'd break character all the time.
No, I think you could.
Breaking character is when they start laughing. They can't do it.
Right. But I think that you have a serious side to you, and if you once you've tried it a few times, you'd get it.
No,
you'd
because
be able to get through it.
I would laugh so much, Steve. Like,
because everything we do is spontaneous, so you never know when the joke's coming. But if it's scripted and written down, you're going to know when it's coming, and you're almost prepared for it. And you've heard it three times, probably.
Yeah,
you know what I mean?
I don't know.
That's all.
I think sometimes I try to look at life. Life is just so fucked up that, and it's such a short ride that we're here. You know, just. And we don't have any real control over what's going to happen. You never know what's going to happen. So just sit back and enjoy the ride. Laugh, you know, laugh.
Life is awesome. I love life. I love every bit of it. I love every morning. I love every day. You know, I go to bed and I'm grateful for everything I have. I don't believe in or subscribe to any of that shit that life's horrible. I really don't believe that at all. It is what you make it. And you know what? Whatever you made it, you try to get through it as best you can.
I called Jeff the Gray out last night, that guy that was so hard to me on Wolfman's show that was going, she's a drama queen. She's a control freak. I called him out right there at the end of the show. Me and Jeff were kind of, I could tell Jeff's a really normal guy. He's like he's a one percenter. Because I said, so Jeff, I go, what did you think of this caller tonight? And he goes, because he knew, he's like, fuck you, Debi, you know? Because there was this really weird guy on Wolfman's show, but you know, that's just.
Yeah, I didn't listen, sorry.
Oh, you didn't catch it.
I don't listen to anybody's show, you know that.
I would ask him a question, and I'm not going to listen to shows either anymore because I can't do it because there's so many paranormal things going on that I don't know. I'm just like,
I don't enjoy the quote unquote topic. So why would I enjoy the show? You know what I mean?
Uh-huh.
I'm not, I like Darren a little bit sometimes. I think when he's on the show with us here,
a little bit, a little bit.
Yeah. You know, I'm not going to commit to a friendship here, but he seems like an all right guy. Wolfman, I don't know enough. I think that he has very funny moments, but his drinking's out of control and he just gets pretty nuts out there. And Kurt, I think, is great. He's a very intriguing guy for sure. Really interesting person. And I guess Joe's out there now with them, and I'd love Joe. Joe's phenomenal. So
well, it's
there's
hard
people out here I'd want to meet, and
it's hard to be on Wolfman's show because Joe Seeker nailed it when he said, "Hold on, just a second, boys. This will not go on the air, but they will hear it in the chat room." Okay, there we go. Now we're back.
Yeah. Well, there you go.
I mean, I think Wolfman has so much talent, but there's just something there.
I was going to respond to it, but then I said I can't because she just said that in secret.
Yeah, but they can hear us over in the other chat room.
Yeah, I got you.
I don't know. I have 49 messages I haven't looked at in my chat room yet. Yeah, it was pretty weird stuff, but yeah.
Well, I'm glad that you're well. Get through this day, and this week has been rough for you. This next week will be better. Positive thinking. I'm moving to Colorado starting Sunday.
What? What the fuck? Yeah. What do you mean?
I got a better offer. I've got to take it. So.
Now, who said that Tina Fey is lesbian?
Her girlfriend.
Tina Fey said, somebody said she's lesbian.
I never heard that.
So Debi goes, I cannot wait to see how a formatted Debi show is going to work out. Oh my God, Debi, you're such
nice,
a fucking
Debi.
Hater.
Be nice, buddy. Come on. You could do it. I remember that one day when you were nice. I remember. It was a few years ago, but you were nice that one day. Do it again, man.
Me?
Him. Stabber.
Oh, it's a don't. There's Dare Eric. Hi, Eric. How are you doing, sweetie? You big mountain with snow on top. Sorry.
What does that mean? He's snow capped?
He's like six. I think he's 6'5" or some shit like that.
Look at he put my favorite co-host is on. Cool.
Who?
That was nice. Eric said that about me.
Eric's voice, I could go to sleep to.
Nice guy.
Every night.
Now I like him. Say nice things, I'll like you. It's simple.
Debi says he's trying to get everybody to that other chat room. And there are some people that are saying behind my back, Debi, that's a big mistake. It's destroying your listening numbers.
I don't know. Well, the thing is, if they weren't there, they'd be in your room and you'd be getting the numbers.
Maybe that's what Stabby's trying to do. I don't know why he did it.
I don't think it's intentional. I thought, remember you had a private chat room before because of the trolling. Remember that room?
When?
Remember we had a secret chat room.
The one out of Iceland or whatever it's called. Where does that idiot and snoozy live? What's it called?
Supposedly Iceland.
No, not Iceland. He lives in something else. He lives
Yeah.
First one he gets at the king. Okay.
Dorkland.
No. Shh. Wait. He lives in. Wait. I'm going to get this before you.
No, you're not. Don't look it up. Don't you look.
I'm not. It's ice. It is.
Iceland.
No,
it's Iceland.
It's not Iceland. Is it Iceland?
It's Icelander, right? He always says, I speak Icelandic.
I speak Icelandic. So it's Reykjavik. Yeah, it's Iceland.
Yeah, I just won $1. What did I win?
We'll find that out.
You said the first one to get it.
You'll have to find that out. You're king of the world now.
Oh, all right. Well, all right. I quit. I don't want to be king anymore.
Yeah, I don't either. So
it's too much work.
Yeah, what it is that I have noticed in the since I stream the show, which I'm doing right now over in the private chat room, mm-hmm. that the numbers are just dog shit. I mean, because when I've been on the air now for 34 minutes, I would already be up to, and I've got nine, I've got 10, of course it is Sunday night. And Sunday nights used to be really big in certain areas, but they're not big where we are now. So, but
yeah.
And this is just a last minute, whatever deal.
I just sent her a little thing. You want to do a show? Cool.
So I want to play, I want to debut Steve doing 25 or 6 to 4. And I'm going to be honest with you.
The critiques again.
No. When Jet was here, I didn't get to listen to the gist of it.
I think the song that you would like the best as far as just a really fun rhythm pattern, it's by the Go-Go's. I know it's a girl band. We Got the Beat. Because that is made for a cajon.
See the people literally walking down the street. I'm very much. I'm an 80s.
Talk about percussion. That is a very, very hard percussive song to play too.
Rocking on the cajon.
It doesn't stop for a fucking second.
Where is your? Okay, okay, you ready to do this?
I sure.
116 views. What the fuck? You're getting more hits than this show's getting.
I'm getting crazy numbers. I had 2,000
That's
in
it.
An
I'm
hour.
Pulling out of the chat room. No more streaming over there. Shut up, Savvy. You just blew it. Goodbye. Go to the show page if you want to hear it.
Yes.
Boom. Palski. Wowski. Bam. 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 All right.
Yeah, I got 1,800 in like an hour and a half.
Yeah. He goes, destroying your numbers is my master plan. I'm going to pretend that was a bit for the show. I think the problem is, Debi, as far as the people who matter, you are literally the only one person who cares. I'm just happy to be hanging out together. And Pockley's goes, Steve talking about someone else's drinking problem?
Yeah. The person that's experienced it, lived it, and fixed it is the person that can talk about it.
I would play some things about how Debi acts, but she would probably leave the chat in a huge huff. So I'll just Debi's attempt at being funny. See the ugliness that Stabby does? It's really ugly the way he is. And I know people that would be around somebody like Stabby that wouldn't put up with it. You know what I'm saying? Because I think that Stabby makes a fool out of himself because he obviously listens to me, and what he says is really stupid. It's like, I would play some things about how Debi acts. What do you mean some things about how Debi acts? What would you play? Something along? Would you do a BTG thing and go way back and play some stuff that Goose altered and spliced? Is that what you're talking about playing, Stabathon?
I don't know.
Just get the fuck along, man, or get out. What the fuck? Okay, here we go with the debut of 25 or 6 to 4 by Steve on the cajon. Looks like Cajun.
It does look like Cajun.
It really does. All right, you ready?
Sure.
I already heard the whole thing. Look, I went through the whole thing. Oh, well, we're going to hear it again. Yeah. All right. Mute. Okay, first thing, where is your input coming from? The input of the sound?
You know what? I have it too close to the microphone, and I realize that.
Because is it the input on your computer?
No. I have a I built a Bluetooth speaker, 2 10-inch in there, and a tweet, and I put that.
What does that even mean?
I built it. It's a portable Bluetooth speaker, so when I play my phone, I can play any song I want wherever I'm at. It's got a battery in it, so I put it in, and it's pretty loud. It's 150 watts. Yeah. So I just place it there and I play the songs I want. And I had it too high, and it was a little over modding. So all of these are going to be redone. If these numbers continue to climb, I'm going to redo them all and do them properly, because there is an interest, obviously. So.
All right, here we go. Also, also, as a housewife, I'm going to have to tell you that you're washing your whites with your darks. You need to stop doing that.
I thought I would break it so many times.
If you delete it, I'll kill you. If you delete it, I'll kill you if it breaks.
No, I would keep that for my blooper reel.
Okay.
For sure. Hey, Debi. Do you hear how many hits are happening at once in this song? I'm hitting six times with my right hand and three times with my left hand every second.
Well, let's just see.
There's nine hits every second.
Here's what I want you to do. I want you to put on some headphones.
I never sounded better.
No, now listen to me. I want you to put on some headphones the next time you go up there or down there in your garage. And I want you to tap out a beat to a song. I will simultaneously, on the next time we're together, play the song matched perfectly, which I can do this, perfectly to the beat. And that's when I want to hear it that way. Because I'm hearing too much of Chicago. And it seems like you're behind just because you're that much further away from the speaker. Does that make sense?
There could be. I'm further away from the microphone, you mean.
I mean the microphone. I'm sorry.
Yeah. But if you listen to We Got the Beat, I think that's pretty – you know, even better. Here's one. And I don't want you to promote this shit. I'm just saying. If you're going to play anything.
It's got one view.
It has what?
One view. What happened to the
Go-Go? It's brand new. I just put it up.
Okay. Here we go. You want to play this one?
No, not that one. But if you open it, you'll see there's more than one view. It just blew up. I just put it out there, and then it went from one view to... No, I've been doing this my whole life. I don't even feel it. It makes your upper body really strong, though.
I want to try my Corona.
You want to hear what?
My Corona.
I love that song. I always have.
Try this one. Here we go. All right, you nailed it.
Thanks.
Debi, I'm wondering if maybe you could play along with some of the ukulele songs I'm thinking. I mean, I don't think you've ever really shown.
Oh, wow. I like that.
I like that, too. Because I don't believe Debi has ever come completely into her power of the ukulele. You know what I'm saying?
Well, there was that one night where she just felt it. She needs to feel it again. And I'll play along with her.
You have no idea how much she needs to feel it again.
What's a deal? It's a bargain, right?
You said she needs to feel it again. I said you have no idea how much she needs to feel it again.
Oh, I missed out
That's
on that
quite
whole
a bit.
Joke.
I just turned your mic off, you piece of crap. No.
At least
yes.
Click like on these videos, dork.
All right, thank already. You. you know something? I don't know. I'm not that. I'm a little
Roxanne, because you play it on your show all the time. I did Roxanne too. Harrison might. Now, George Harrison, there's no drums to it. So you could critique that one.
Okay.
I'll let you recreate. Because there's no percussion at all.
There we go.
Except a tambourine. So I was thinking of a way to go into it. And I was like slowly going into it. And then I find my beat right here.
See if there's somebody else that's doing this sound different. I think you got the talent. I think it's the sound that's getting to me. The sound.
That's 67 views in an hour.
I understand that, but I'm just saying I want it.
No, I know. No,
I want it to be perfect for you, and I want to see if there's a way that we can set up your speaker system here. You know what I'm saying?
Yeah. I totally need a new setup. This is temporary. In Colorado, I've got a bigger house, so, and I'm going to mic everything. I'm going to mic the cajon.
I don't know.
So it goes to a different board.
Listen, look at his headphones. You don't have headphones on. You didn't on the lesson.
No, I don't. Okay. I do not have headphones on.
Let's see if we can find one where they're doing a song. I don't see a song here.
She's amazing, that girl right there.
Is she
I
good?
Love her. Yeah, she's phenomenal.
Yeah, but they're probably
She's one of my inspirations.
She's probably just playing the cajon, right? There's no music.
Yeah. No, she teaches you. In fact, I watched a few of your things that she taught me about hand placement and where to hit and how to hit and how to. They call it striking. You don't hit it, you strike it. A stick hits something.
Here we go. Here we go with Bruno Mars, Treasure on the cajon. Let's see what his setup is. I see headphones.
Watch how gentle he's playing this.
Oh, you've seen all these.
No, but I just know how people play the cajon. I play it completely different.
I just want to see if he's matched better with the sound. It's more.
Yeah, it's a production studio.
More
look at
synced
that.
Up. This
the
is
whole studio doing this. Yeah.
This? How do you know that?
Yeah. It hasn't look at the logo. I mean, they put some money into it.
We're going to do something with your sound. We're going to do it.
Yeah, I think I need to.
Because all these
I know I need to. Right now, I'm just having fun with it.
Oh, I know, and I love it. I think it's great. I think it's wonderful.
What I thought I would do, seriously, is like I always said, I'm going to test the waters. I'm going to put a few videos out there and see what people do. And at first, nobody even listened. And then now I played a few songs where people have told people about it. You know what I mean?
Maybe you're going to be a complete rock star.
Never.
Here's somebody in their garage with headphones on. You need headphones on, sweetest. Okay.
Yeah, I know. It would help a little
bit. Let's try this and see how he does. He's obviously not professional here, so. Oh, don't even start it, you stupid.
But look at his views. He's almost 50,000 views.
It's not going to play because something is wrong with my YouTube on Chrome. I don't know what it is. It just does this all.
Just go to your where it says hi-fi. See where your settings are? On the bar, down at the bottom.
Where? What?
Okay, look down at the bar where it shows you how long it's going to play. All the way to the right, you see the little screw with the HD?
Uh-huh.
Click on that. Go to from 480 to 260. 240.
I don't want to do that. I mean, why would I do that?
You would do that so that way you could watch the video. Watch it pop up now.
I don't think it is. I mean, It's just, there's something with my thing with YouTube. I don't know. Maybe they just don't like me. Maybe they're haters.
I hope not.
Maybe they're jealous haters.
Sons of bitches.
I don't know. I want you to be, I mean, I'm just, that's my love for people is I want the best. Now there's other people that won't say that to you, but you have to understand what's really caring for somebody means. It's wanting them to be the best. And I want you to be the best. Look at that.
I appreciate it.
Look at this. What is this?
Oh,
I
want that's blood. a tambourine.
I know
tambourine
that.
On his foot. It's ridiculous,
that.
Debi. My career, I just sound my tambourine.
Let's see. Saturday morning, jumped out of bed, put on my best suit. So he's listening to that on his iPhone with his headphones on. So there's no music in the room that he's in. Does that make sense?
I don't know how he's doing that. Well, how are we hearing it? Is it patched through to the camera?
He's recording it. And
listening to it.
There's no music in the room, in the open room.
Mm-hmm.
You know, like out here where I am or out there where you
right.
are.
No, I know what you're saying. There's no speakers on in the room. Only he's hearing it.
Yeah, it'd be like me trying to sing karaoke through my speakers. It wouldn't work.
So what I'm wondering is how is the recorder, videotape, getting the audio?
Well, he's obviously got a separate video here that's just videoing him, but the sound is coming off of this right here.
Mm.
You know what I'm saying? Do you understand
yeah,
what I'm saying?
Yeah, no, I do. I totally understand. Okay. Let's hear all these sounds. Got in my car, rest like a jet.
Understand why doesn't anybody ever go down here? They're just
remember you asked me that question. See all the screws? Those are all the tuning screws. Because down there, it's really nothing. There's the snare isn't there.
Why isn't it just this little? I mean, I'm such a
and that's Latin percussion. That's the one I own. That's an Alpine. Like up at the top where his fingers are, that's the snare's at. Then lower is toms, and then the middle is the bass, and then you have toms on the side. If you know how to tone it right, you can get a lot of sound out of this stupid box.
I think it's cute. I like it. I really do. I think it's cute.
Isn't it cool for like, I'm a nervous person. You remember you were saying you love my nervous energy?
Mm-hmm.
I have that. I have that when I play, it comes out in bursts. So depending on what song I'm playing, like I'm fucking so into
Joe
it.
Joe Seeker would tell you you're on cocaine.
No, I've been accused because I've always been in bands. I've always been accused of being on drugs because of my energy level and being thin. They're like, dude, you must do a lot of coke. I'm like, I've never touched that shit in my life.
You know, there's people.
It's just naturally
there's
that
people
way.
In the world that people, some people dare not accost, question, because they fear the odds. Those are the people that I push, because I'm like, you're nothing special, and I'm not talking about Joe Seeker in particular, but I'm just saying. There's somebody that goes, oh, ooh, I can't believe it. Like when I said something earlier, Stevie went snap, like, oh, fuck. You know, I would never do that. But what makes somebody else so special that they can't be? Questioned about their what they say or what they do. Why are they so special? I mean, you know what I'm saying? I hate people.
I don't know, but here's my thought on it.
Mm-hmm.
If for any reason, if anybody questions what you're doing, then go out and do it better. Don't tell me about it. Show me it. You know, grab a cajon. They're $100. Record a few songs and play better than me. And then I'll be inspired by you. And I'll say that to anybody. I mean, when you play better than me, then I'll learn from you and I'll appreciate that. But to down anybody or degrade anybody just because, you know, you have nothing better to do or whatever, it's ridiculous. And I mean that to anybody who is just negative about something. Just pick it up and try it yourself. And you'll realize it's not as fucking easy as it looks. It's really not. Music's complicated. Music has signatures and time and frames. And all those bars have to match. And the minute that they don't, you sound like shit. And it's all a mess. So music's all about structure and form. And once you understand the structure and the form, and you could play within that, without going over or under, you're doing all right. So when people downed anything I would do percussive or vocally, I said, at least I'm trying. You know, show me better ways, and I may approach it that way, to be fair.
What is a word for not nervous, but what is it? It is. I forgot what it's called.
Like anxious?
No, you're always
hyper.
No. Listen to me. You always think everybody's against you. What's that called? You're
pessimist.
No, you're
God, I'm cynical.
No, I'm thinking she's so. I never
defensive. Defensive.
No, not defensive. Well, it could be defensive, but I'm thinking of something else rather than defensive. It's more like.
Combative, like
paranoid. That's what I'm thinking of.
Yeah. My dictionary ran out there. No, I don't think it's that at all. I think it's interesting. I think it's important to tell people how you feel. Do you know what I mean?
Oh, Little Miss Heck says you sound hot. She's beautiful.
Oh, she's cool as hell. I love her. I'm friends with her on Twitter.
I know.
And I always retweet her stuff because she's a rock star. I love her.
Thank you, Darren.
Very, very cool.
That's what I was looking up, is paranoid. Steve is hot. I don't hang around people that aren't hot. You're hot. You're hot as fuck, Little Miss Hex.
Yeah, you are.
Good Put a Lord hex on quarter. Me, you little cup of, you little cup of, you little
cup of. Cup of cream.
Cup of warm milk on a cold night.
Well, now we're adding to it. I love it.
Yeah. I just
like saying what I feel instead of people wondering what I do. Like, and I'm always honest. And I could take it, and it's not paranoia. It's just letting people know what wavelength I'm on.
Yeah,
instead of people guessing. I don't want people guessing.
I think it's better to be that way than to just blow smoke up people's asses. You know, I do think she's hot. I think she's pretty. I've seen her pictures on Twitter, and she puts on a good show. They put on a crazy show the other day.
She's very good at what she does. Absolutely.
I got to show you what these crazy fucks did the other day. I was like, my son was here, okay? And my son goes, what are you listening to? It was that amazing. It was that, I put it in backwards. Sorry. They were playing, it was one, because they have music that will, their music will just kill you, okay?
Yeah. We've listened to the shows together. I was in there with you.
Well, they had a show on Friday that was called, not The Real Joker. It was, let me see, what was Friday, baby? See, what is today? Today's the 14th. So Friday was the
12th.
The 12th, okay. And it was State of Play with Subs, all right? You would love Lurking Lady, too. I was in the chat room, and I said, what the fuck? This music was off the wall. And look at all the music that this chick played. And it was, I don't know the names of it, but, okay, wait. She played Stressed Out, then she played, it was right after she played, hold on. I think it was this. No, that's not it. It must have been, because I thought it was a little bit later on, but where do they get this music?
I don't know.
Here it is. She played Handlebars, and I said in the chat room, that's supposed to be about Hitler or a powerful, and I think it was, then she played another song after that, and I was like, wow. Then she nails it. It was like, I was like, what the crap is that? I mean, it was, and even my son came in the room and he goes, what are you listening to? Like, what radio station is this? It was so good. Let me see if it was Mumford & Sons' Little Lion Man.
Read for yourself, my man. You'll never be what is in your heart.
It was the one after this. I listened to the whole show. Nope. Let me try this one. This was it. Listen to this. Listen to this, Steve. question. Where do these Anons get this music? Is this what they play in the UK?
It's not underground.
No,
it's not underground.
Is this what they play in the UK?
Maybe. This is like house music. This is amazing stuff.
Oh, it gets worse. I mean, it gets unbelievable. It's just like
gets worse. It gets better.
No, I mean, it was crazy. Unbelievable. I was going, this music is crazy. But the song that she played was long, and I'm seeing that at 104 she started this one, and it went all the way to 110. So that's what, 6 minutes? I bet it was Griffin and Bipolar Sunshine by Ho Heart, the BK Muse remix. And I just go, they don't even realize how many times I'm in there. I'm in there all the time just listening to their music. Have you ever heard Rabbit? One time she did nothing but just bonk, 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 bonk. You were there that day, weren't you? It was just this insane bouncing stuff. It was like bonk, 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 bonk. It was nuts.
I have really great headphones. Mm-hmm. I have these Hyper 3s. I love them. Mm-hmm. And they, like, when you were playing that, mm-hmm. I turned it up on my end. It's just, like, so good.
Let's
so
try
that
this
room,
one.
That room is a blast.
I know, and they're insane. They're so, I mean, what I mean is they're, because you have to be careful when you're talking to people from other countries. What I mean by that is they're insanely good.
Right,
I mean,
right.
It's a
fun room.
When I owned a bridal shop, it was called Michelle's Bridal Informal. I named it after my daughter's middle name. And down the way from me in the strip mall that I was in, there was a woman from Pakistan that owned a hairdressing salon, and she had a friend come down one day to get a dress from me to do something, and I said, oh, I just love her, she is crazy. Well, about 2 weeks later, she was snubbing me in the parking lot, and I said, is there something wrong? And she goes, you tell my friend I'm crazy. I said, no, wait a minute, whoa, stop. I said, I meant that as, because she was real funny, and she goes, how come you tell her I'm crazy? I was like, oh, fuck.
Wait, how did she say it?
Why you tell my friend I'm crazy? And I started to say, because you're... No, but I'm... So what I mean by that...
Talking about paradise.
And sometimes I'll say people are so stupid. I'll say, oh, my God, he is so stupid. He just cracks me up.
It's a compliment.
You calling me stupid? Is that what you're saying for me right now? I'm going to cut you. Look, I'm going to kill somebody if I don't find that song that was...
I'm going to kill you if you don't.
Wait a minute. I said, what the hell is this song? Oh, no. Mr. Potts. Mr. Potts is a crazy guy. He's insane. He was in my room the other day.
Yeah.
Oh, I said... Let me see how far back it is, and that way I'll know if it's in the middle of the show. Okay. They said, is Bob Dylan dead or is this bullshit? And then I said, oh, my God, this music is great. Okay, now let's look over here. We're more towards, wait a minute, fuck, what? How far does this go down? Ugh, I don't know. I can't see. I don't know what song it was. And sometimes I ask, what song are you playing? They'll all be posted after the show, Debi. I'm like, okay. All right, there we go.
Aren't they?
Yeah,
well, they are, I guess.
Okay, we're at the end. So I said that at approximately, hold on.
I was wearing jeans, and I remember wearing a loose top.
The last thing I remember was somebody touched my drink, and I was like, what are you doing? No, I'm joking.
Right, exactly.
Okay, here we are.
Oh, my God, this music is great. GR8.
But it's up here towards the... It's towards the end of the first third. See how smart I am?
The end of the first third.
We don't do quarters, we do thirds. So it'd be one, two, see, hold on, Debi. If you divide it by, it's going to be this song, I bet, that I liked. It was after she played Handlebars. You know what? I'm fixing to get really sad here. Wait a minute. I'm going backwards. Is this the one she plays after this?
Wow. Ladies and gentlemen, we're glad you can come in tonight and hear what happened on another show that may have not happened. No, they it's a lively room. It's a fun room for sure.
Look what I just did. Forget it. Fuck it. They're good. If you want to hear some good music, I mean some really good music. Now here's what I would play on my show. Here we go with the song, everybody. What is this? You know, they have this one guy that does nothing but remixes, and he's like his name is like Manja or Manjana or something.
It's manjolecato.com.
I knew that. I was trying to think of that. But he's really good too. I like him, and I used to like Jesus.
Remember, you used to always play Joey? I did Joey on the cone.
To Joe?
I've loved that song my whole life. Like, my whole life. Ever since it came out, like, I thought it was Concrete Blonde was great. I heard that song, and I'm like, I'm going to play that. So, that's
fun. Highly recommend if you want to hear some good music. And Stabby's good with music too. Stabby plays amazing music. His taste in music, I could listen to.
It's weird. He's got a very diverse taste.
I would not touch the remote, and I would not touch his stereo unit. I would just sit back and I would just fold his clothes and smell of his neck sometimes. I'm joking. But it's just, some people have this bizarre taste in music that is amazingly good, and it's stuff that you would never think of.
Yeah, it's very creative thinking. Stabby instead of that normal, same good, show, same
yeah. Yeah, but still, there's a place for that in my life. Like when I play classic rock, when people hear that, they're really taken back to the older times when they think of that song. So I don't have a, we have to have people like me around that like things like classic rock. You know what I'm saying?
Absolutely. Well, I'm one of those guys, and that's why I thought that when they invented, like Latin percussion came out, and they made their bongo series, and then they made the cajon series, and they made their drum series. That was all intended for softer, like Bruno Mars, like you heard that guy playing. It was never intended for classic rock. That's why I took up the challenge. Because nobody's doing it. Nobody's playing Zeppelin or heavy metal on a cajon. And I'm like, that's the reason why I'm doing it, because nobody's doing it. I think it's a little niche that you'd have a good time. If you read, I put it in the caption. I think you'd have a good time just trying this. Don't down it. Yes, we got the beat by the Go-Go's. You'd never think of somebody playing that on a fucking cajon. But it worked for me. If you listen to the whole thing to the end, right to the end, it was just fun. There you are.
Play it. Sharona. Okay, I heard this song the other day when I was listening to my classic rock station, which is, of course, 92.5 KZPS Lone Star, Texas. And when I heard this, I thought, it took me back to a time I thought, oh my God, I forgot how much I love that freaking song. And this is a song. No, I'm joking. This song is about loss of, and I know you've had great loss in your life, like I've had great loss in my life. And it tells the story of how there's a part in this song when it says, I don't know how I'm going to do this. Where are you? And if you listen very carefully, you'll hear the other person say, I'm gone away. He goes, I'm gone away. And then he says, I've got to survive. I've got to, or something. It's about loss and how to survive loss. All right. So maybe we need to hear this today since some of us have not survived. Shut up, Debi. Here we go. We'll be right back.
Turned on the light. day. Pride will tear us both apart. Well, now pride's gone out the window, cross the rooftops, run away.
That is beautiful.
Listen right here where he goes. He goes, where is the life that I recognize? Listen for the voice to go, gone away. I think that is so cool right here.
Forgot tomorrow. Ooh, yeah. Beside the news of holy war and holy me, ours is just a little sorrow.
Debi, turn it off for a second. Steve.
What's up? What's up, buddy?
I dated Simon LeBone.
Did you? You got a little bondy, William? Did you bond?
I lived with him for 3 months in 1985.
Well, don't cry. It's okay. So you used Simon LeBone?
No, you don't get it. That song was written for me, Steve. Okay?
Oh.
I'm the one that... I even was the voice that goes, went away. Or gone away, whatever the fuck it was. I was high.
Well, it was a long time ago.
I was
and you were emotional and distracted, so
I wanted to marry that. Just stop it. I can talk. She's in the bathroom, you asshole. I'm sorry.
Yeah, chill out.
It's Tyrone.
She's got her ankle bracelet on.
Okay,
we know where she's at.
I have to read the following announcement. Hold on. Give me the son of a bitch, you stupid idiot. All right, hold on.
I love when you do that.
What the fuck is it? Hold on. Hold on, Tyrone. Hello, people of the Debi Daily Show. The following is our May special. You get in a goodie bag from... Hold on. I'm not reading this. Get out of here. I'm not reading that shit. Fucking
is
drug ad.
Talk to her for 5 seconds. I will.
Okay, you're stepping over my bid here. Hold on.
I didn't mean to. Somebody just got in my face. Okay.
I think Debbie's... Are you back, beloved? Hold on.
Beloved.
Yes, I'm back. And you don't have to throw the flower petals. It's stupid. My God.
Anyway, well, you know.
Well, he's got this little midget guy that's throwing flower petals every time I walk. Get him out of here.
Why is he a midget?
I will read. No, I will do it for Tyrone because he mowed the lawn and you didn't do anything. Okay. For $171, that's what I owe a bill. Let's see. For $171, the May special for Tyrone, Ray Ray, and Pookie is, what does it say? You get, what? You get 3.85 grams of your choice. You get your choice of indica, sativa, or what they call boom boom. And then for this is not bad. You also get with that your choice of 50 Zanipars and what? This doesn't make any sense, Tyrone.
For how much?
Do it right.
I'm in. I know. The price is right.
Hold on just a second. I can't even read your writing. You're an idiot. But you did do the lawns well. Thank you. Anyway, I'm not going to do that.
It figures they'd be good with grass.
Yeah, really. That's probably what they're selling for so cheap. But he sends out so many of those packs. You wouldn't believe it. When he had the March Madness sale, he was doing a pound of sativa with 30 Zanny bars, 30 hits of acids, and a great big some kind of a scoop. He was doing of meth. I was like, what? For how much?
Damn.
It was $100.
I don't know how he stays in business.
But I will say this: a lot of my bath salts were missing. So y'all be careful. I mean, because I don't know.
That's not good. That could go south fast.
I can
fast.
Say exactly what I want to say. I don't care what you do, because the bath salts were gone out of the guest bath outside in the pool bath. They were gone. Yes. I'm sorry.
Well, you would know.
Well, yeah. I mean.
Jesus. It's like you live there. It's not easy living with people. You guys that are listening.
Put it down. Stop it. You know, Pookie is scared to death of Hank.
Americans? Yeah.
That's a nice way of saying it. Yes. Mine are not African American. Mine are Americans.
Your dogs?
I'm an African American. Why did we just lose signal? No, we're back. Okay. Stop it, you piece of crap, Spreaker.
Yeah.
I will hop this thing in a New York minute.
I will whoop your ass.
No, I will hop this.
Oh, I'll say it the way I want to say it. So there.
Dog catching piece of crap. No. Steven called his attorney to go take care of that dog catcher ticket. I mean, the dog at large ticket. When he retrieved Hank.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah. I wanted to show you what Steven gave me. He said, hold on. It's a report card. It says to Mommy, MOMMY. They both still call me Mommy, which is probably weird for you. Okay.
No.
Mom, where there was no pain, you cleared. Where there was no path, you cleared one. You made it smooth and lit the way with love and constant support. And you know, he didn't even... Who reads cards? I just buy what they look good. You know?
It's colorful. It's got to be good.
And then he wrote, Happy Mommy's Day, Mommy. And I said, Stephen, you didn't sign it. He goes, oh, well, I forgot. Do you know Stephen? Stephen quit his main job because he's making more money on Twitch.
Yeah.
Yep.
It can happen. It can certainly happen.
He gave it 6 months to see if it would be that way. Steven is a known player in the game world. And what he plays right now, what he's dominating, is Call of Duty, it's Call of Duty something.
Yeah, and Black Ops was the one I had. I know it's the new one.
And he had that Twitch money going to his PayPal, and he it's really weird how they do the payment system with these guys, because there's four on a team, and they don't just split whatever they get that night in tips. It's whoever did whatever or something like that. You know, whoever did the best.
The most kills?
Yeah, I guess, or something like that. Yeah. And he had that going to his PayPal account, and he said that he was noticing over the first few weeks that it was doing more than his regular, you know, go to work job. And he didn't even tell me this. He just wasn't, hey man, today was my last day on my job. I said, what? And Heather's always going, man, Steven is flush, Mom. He's flush. I go, how do you know? She goes, because I saw his bank account. I opened his bank account one day. I said, Heather? Anyway.
Steven. You know, what the hell was I going to ask you? I had a perfectly good question. I swear I did. Just a moment ago, I left it laying right here.
Was it about Twitch?
No.
Playing games? Quitting your account? PayPal? Steven?
PayPal. PayPal's amazing. And I was going to ask, does he play on PlayStation 4, right?
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
Okay.
And Xbox.
Be careful. I had gotten like 5 people try to break into my PlayStation account.
Oh, don't worry about it.
I keep getting the reports back that another one averted. Somebody trying to, you know, get into your account, change password. Someone changed my password a month later. Somebody's trying to get in again. Because I always have a card with money on there. I always have, you know, so I could buy a game. You know what I mean? I go on Steam and I could buy games and stuff. So
when Steven buys something online, he has a stack of those temporary Visa cards that you buy in the drugstores and stuff. I bet he has a box full of those things because he will just buy one. If he's going to even just buy anything online, he'll give that one. And he'll go get another one, then another one, then another one, then another one, then another one. Because he will not give anybody on the internet his bank account, his Visa or his debit.
Well, that's smart.
And then one time what he did is he just went and bought a stack of them that were like just worth whatever. He had one for 50, one for – and that's what he does. And that's how he pays for things on the internet. And I thought, man, how did I make him so smart or something?
Yeah, it's a little bit more expensive because it's like $5 to activate it and shit like that. But I mean,
yeah,
if
you've
got
two to
$400 on there, it's better than somebody getting to your bank account, your real money.
Uh-huh. And I'll tell you something else. They've got algorithms. Okay, for example, I bought one of those cards one time and I paid for a subscription service to some bullshit thing. And then I just didn't do it anymore. I accidentally went with that card and loaded that sucker up one time with $600 and boom, they hit it just like that. And
really?
Yeah. So they've got an algorithm that's hitting these cards. Ka-choom, 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 ka-choom. And it's hitting them constantly because I guess they figured out people do that. Because I was looking on the subscription, the online thing of it. And I thought, I was so mad because I'll join something and I just won't renew. And the the card had laid. Hanks drinking.
I hear it.
I know. I'm sorry. That's my dog drinking out of the toilet.
It's part of the show, guys. It's the ambiance.
Yeah. But it's like I was so shocked. I thought, I haven't been to that site. It was a VPN site called CyberGhost. And it was $6.95 a month. And all of a sudden I went, oh my God, they hit that card for like boom, 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 boom. Do you know what I mean?
Yeah, PayPal's the shit. Yeah, they can. I'm sure there's ways of knowing. You know, I always said that it'd be a shame if these people with all these skills that have all these ways of thinking about getting around anything but work would work. You know what I mean? Like for something productive. Like people in prison, the shit that they make out of a fucking bar of soap and a toothpick. It's like they can make a radio out of that somehow. It's like genius.
I actually have one of those radios.
A soap radio?
I've had
Was it on a rope?
I've had it for years. No, I'm not a guy. I don't have to have soap on a rope. If I've been over to pick up the soap, I welcome anything. No, I'm joking.
You're such a dork.
You're so stupid.
Anyway, that's my story, and I'm sticking to it.
But you talked about Duran Duran's Reflex. I think that's a pretty good. That was more like a happy, happy dance song. I think Duran Duran, Simon Le Bon was – what am I hit? What did I just hit? Oh.
Buttons.
I think that Simon Le Bon was one of those deep, deep poet kind of guys that really was, you know, ahead of his time. And I think that people that they called ahead of their time – I've got my quotation fingers up – are really people that are ahead of us. I mean, they're just deep thinkers. You know what I mean?
They see it and produce it a whole different way.
Well, I wouldn't say that. That's what you would say. What I would say is they are people that, like, I think that Paul Simon. People mm-hmm. say, oh, he was way ahead of his time. Well, he could have been, but I think that Art Garfunkel was the one that was truly – it's people that spend time alone. It's people that reflect and it's the thinkers.
How do we explain the Beatles? How do we explain a band that
– The White Album,
In the 60s – wait. Let me – real quick. In the 60s, they were making music that is comparable to today and better. And you're talking 40 – 50 years ago, they were making music that was better than anything today. Maybe not just in my opinion, but millions and millions of people feel the same way. like the substance, the lyrics, the harmonies, the four-part harmony, the timing. It was never complicated. It just kept you in the groove. It kept you in the song. It never stepped over the lyrics. It was just brilliant.
The only thing I can say is that I did read something where John Lennon did say, and George agreed with him, that if you listen to everything prior to the White Album in Sgt. Pepper, that's when they were just, he called them mop tops. They were just like, I want to hold your hand. And then they discovered not the Dalai Lama, but what was his name? Hare Krishna. When they went over and got with the Hare Krishna and they started smoking whatever, you know.
Hashish.
That's when their minds, he said, the blossom, because what that is, you know, dopamine causes, you know, that. And he said that that's the difference between that and Sgt. Pepper, of course, was really when they went into psychedelic time. Not psychedelic, but
hey, they were doing psychedelics. Absolutely.
No, I'm not talking psychedelic. What is it called? I've depended too much on Victor all my life to tell me words. Not psychotropic drug, but hallucinogenics. Okay. When they started doing hallucinogenics in writing and performing and recording on the hallucinogenics, that was Sgt. Pepper. Because that was mad, crazy
deep.
Crap.
It was deep, Deb. And it wasn't, here's the thing. It wasn't stupid. Like, okay, there's deep music that's just stupid. No, I know you're not. I know you're not.
I said it was crazy. It was,
right.
You know?
I know you're not saying it's stupid. I know you would never say that because you know it's a piece of genius. And you listen to that album, it's like everything's – it's a little weird and you have this whole orchestra going nuts and playing backwards and then they go right back into the song without missing anything. It's like they took you on this little trip in the middle of a tune that you would never expect to go on and you land – right back into the song. And that's genius.
Well, yeah. John Lennon said that Ringo was just a well-paid roadie, you know, basically, because he never came up with shit. He never wrote anything. He never contributed. And I wonder sometimes if they really shorted him on the money a little bit, you know?
You know what? He was doing Thomas the Train. He was the voice for Thomas the Train. You know that, right?
Yeah.
Yeah, so I thought he's a multi-billionaire.
He was more than Thomas the Train. He did a whole thing. That was a whole cartoon thing series, wasn't it? Or
he did. He did a documentary as well.
I don't know.
For PBS, yeah. Because he didn't need the money. He did it for charity. He didn't do that for money.
You know, for a long time, I read – I've got some coffee table books out. Well, my whole house is books. But
here's a good – wait, what, while we're on the Beatles, I'm sorry.
Wait, let me write this down so I don't forget it. Hold on.
Right, God, wait. We're like
hold
in
on.
A home.
No, I've always been this way. I was going to tell you about – hold on. Wait, don't talk. I was going to say John Lennon said – see, I forgot my thought. I forgot. It was really cool too.
I'm sorry.
Okay, go ahead.
No, now I feel bad. I'm just going to sit there in the corner and suck my thumb.
For a long time, John Lennon said that they were competing with the Beach Boys. That was their biggest competition. And the Beach Boys, there was nothing deep about that. It was just all, you know, bob, bob, bob. It was just all a bunch of
– It was pretty damn good.
It was just a bunch of noise, so, you know, but – I know, but they got really serious when, you know, when they
– Hare Krishna got in their life. They got real deep. They got religious and got high and got
– Well, they got high.
To a different zone.
Like, you've been listening to me all night just talk. I am now going to get – the bong out, and I'm going to take a couple of hits of my wonderful, cool, beautiful, very expensive indica, and we'll see if my personality changes, shall we?
Sure.
Here we go.
Then I'm going to ask you a question. What you're listening to, ladies and gentlemen, is our host, and she's going to partake in a little bit of fun. If you'd like to, please join the call.
I think it's a way of life. I just don't see how people get...
I do. Well, it's become a way
of life. How do people get by without this stuff? How do you survive in the world?
I literally don't know how I did.
It's such a buffer. It's like...
I swear to God.
Anyway. All right. That's one. I have to finish emptying out the bong. I should do an angry bong hit the way he does it. He always goes... How does he,
like a
get
boss.
Right by the, here we go. He goes... That was too much of a hit. Wait a minute. And I haven't even unplugged the little... I haven't taken the little top off thingy, you know? Now I did.
I'll be talking you down off a ledge in a few minutes. That's how I get.
There we go. Okay. All right.
So
now we'll
here's
see.
My question for you. Here's my okay. I have a question for you. So let's see if uh-huh. this hits you. It should hit you really quick, I'm sure. All right. Who is the only Beatle? Well, the first Beatle to have a number one song solo.
After the breakup?
Yeah. No, I don't know if it was during the breakup. But it was their first independent song.
I didn't know they did that.
I don't know if they did either, so I can't
Why
say.
Why are you asking me that?
No, but I know who did. Who had the
Paul
first
McCartney
number
and
one
Wings.
Song.
Paul McCartney and Wings took off like they had wings.
The first number one song was My Sweet Lord, George Harrison. Everybody would think Paul McCartney or John Lennon. You would think somebody else, but fucking...
No, I've always maintained that George Harrison was the deepest, most spiritual member of that band.
You always said that. Yeah, you always have said that. So I redid that song tonight and put it out there.
What, while we're talking? What do you mean you redid it?
Not just now.
What do you mean? While we were on hold? While I was on hold?
While we were listening to Duran Duran, I was playing a different song.
You got two microphones, and on the other microphone, you're leaning over going, My sweet Lord.
Jade. I always call you Jade. Debi told me to use my headphones, so I didn't take them off.
Yeah.
No. So, no, I played it on the cajon because there is no drums to it. So I'm like, I'm going to put this beat to it. And I love it. I'm really, really happy with it. So it was really, really fun.
Maybe you should do, I'm all about that bass, about that bass, about that bass.
Mm-mm, I'm not going to embarrass myself.
That is the difference between, I was playing that one night. I was playing Taylor Swift, who I think is very pretty, very, mm-hmm. very, 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 very pretty. But her music is so not deep, and I was comparing the Taylor Swift, I guess you could say, of our days, which was Stevie Nicks, and the deep meanings and stuff in the songs that she did. You know, anytime she would call out Sarah, that was the child that she lost with mm-hmm. Don Henley. In almost every song, she would just all of a sudden just go Sarah, just say that word because she. You okay, Steve?
Yeah, I'm sorry. I just moved my mic. I apologize.
No problem. She was carrying that torch, which a lot of people have figured out why I always end my song with an angel flying too close to the ground. I mean, my show ended mm-hmm. with that. That's a tribute.
For Sky.
Yeah, it's a tribute to Sky and my little brother, especially Sky. Because, you know, Jay, I don't look at him I don't look at him in that light. Like, he was broken. Sky was broken. And came isn't to me. Uh-huh.
Yeah. Isn't it amazing how you can hear a song and it brings you to a person?
You know, I think that people that are lived a charmed life, you know, I have this mirror in front of me that is larger at the bottom. And now I look like I have a little tiny shrunken head in this mirror. It's the reflection of this thing I got.
It's that last bong hit that really got you.
See, there you go. See, look, there you are. There you go. That's good. But look how this idiot spelled Jason. Jason. You know, people have
yeah, that's pretty bad.
Have titles of podcasts that are all spelled wrong. I'm going, people,
I know.
go to dictionary.com or something. I mean, I can't imagine doing that. What?
Well, yeah, you're a great speller. But there's some people that aren't, and they do it really fast.
You have a chat message from Dr. Bristle.
My pumpkin head. You stay away from those mean men at that other show.
We'll beat him up for you. Don't worry about it.
Wait a minute. He says, some social justice asshole is circulating. What? An anti-brony petition? What? Declare My Little Pony a hate symbol? Oh, tell him to call me.
There you go.
We'll start a petition against their petition. I don't know if he's listening or not. He's fixing to graduate from college.
He's a good guy. He's a really good guy.
That's the president's thing. Okay.
Yeah, there you go. You're brilliant.
Let's start a counter troll. I mean, petition. Oh, there is a counter petition. See, look at that. We're mind melding. We are hive minds, Dr. Bristle.
It's like you two are one in the same.
Well, it's actually just we're hive minds.
Shut up. You're one in the same.
I'm not a young graduate from college that's a brony. Although I do support the bronies.
I know you do.
I'm going to sign trying to think.
I still have my little brony thing you made me.
When you were real tall.
Yeah, and I had the bigger horn. I said, I have to have a horn.
Yeah, I gave you. You were a unicorn.
I was a blue unicorn of happiness and joy and light. Cheeseburgers. Call in.
Call in if you want to, anybody, but I know they won't because we're mad because she won't stream it in the chat room. And she said, if you say something naughty poo poo about Stabby, it's like a 24-hour get over it deal with them. I'm like, get over it, clown. Okay.
That's a great song. Get over it. I'm in such a musical mood. It's ridiculous. We could talk about music all night tonight, and I just would be on it because, God, I love it. It's so important to me. Important to everybody, but Steve, be quiet. She's typing.
I'm done. All right. Okay. Can you see what I wrote?
Yeah.
Okay. Don't say anything. I am so hungry. Are you hungry?
See.
Oh, that's asking me.
No, I wasn't asking you.
Tell Vic Johnny T said hello because he knows he's a big fan. So.
Magic winner.
What did you say, Victor? What?
Taco bueno.
What? What does that have to do with Johnny T saying hello to him?
Johnny T says hello, sweetie.
Tell Johnny T a hello.
What has happened?
Yeah, kiss.
Thank you, Victor.
Vic, you could sing, dude. I didn't realize that the pipes.
That's actually nice. Goofy Bone, but anyway.
I like it. It's all I know is I want a copy. I'm going right now to get a copy.
Yeah. So what did we learn tonight? Listen to the Yawn UK radio for good music.
Absolutely. And a great chat room, cool atmosphere. But if you're a dickhead, don't go in there because you won't last. They'll leave you alive.
What song do you want to hear, Victor? I mean, Steve?
I'll listen to anything.
I would like to hear
some Beatles. I'd like to hear Eleanor Rigby.
I don't know if I can do it.
As you know, that's my favorite song outside of anything by Rush.
What was wrong with Eleanor Rigby?
What was wrong with her?
Mm-hmm.
She had a bad attitude. No. What do you mean, what was wrong with her?
I studied
that. She was alone.
I took three separate courses. I mean, three separate years, you know, can I help you?
Yeah, food.
Can I help you?
That's fine. Whatever. Can we maybe change up a little bit? Get something else instead of just the same old thing? No, I know.
Prepare.
There's also Whataburger.
Hmm?
Whataburger.
That's okay.
What, do you need money or?
No, I just wanted to use Whataburger. Number one.
No.
With that.
I do the number, wait a minute. I do the number seven with no tomatoes. No, no salad at all. Just
number
whatever.
Six.
Surprise me.
With that sauce on it, that A1 sauce.
Yes, but I don't want to think about it right now.
Okay, and then fries?
Well, of course, but don't eat them on the way home.
Chocolate shake?
No, I don't need that. I'll just take water or something.
Okay.
Wow, you guys sound like you're in love.
What do you mean? I've been with this clunkhead for too long.
I was married three times, and I never had a conversation that nice.
I'm tired of being married.
Okay.
It's nothing personal. I'm sure somebody else would really like you a lot, but it's just kind of gets a little old after a while.
I'm sure
everything gets stale.
Steve, let him talk. What did you say?
I'm sure I can find someone.
Fuck you. Get out of here.
Ooh.
I buy
he
you.
He counter-trolled you.
Yeah, he's a pretty hardcore troll. God damn it.
Yeah.
No, Stabby's going to catch it. Well, no, he won't tonight because I actually said something to his sensitive nature. Wait a minute. We have to hear.
I think Gunner's Tail could play that box at Steve's.
Fuck you.
He said, Chuck you, Farley. No, Gunner's Tail is like a... It's time
that
for
my
us,
dog's the same thing.
It's time for us to hear our latest... Thank you, Gunner. Time for our latest sponsor... Because if I say anything negative poo-poo, it is time for...
From the makers of Tickle Me Elmo and Tickle Me Elmo Extreme comes this holiday season's hottest must-have toy. It's Tickle Me...
Stabby.
Stabby, that hurts me. It
Tickle Me
Stabby.
Oh, is the tortured, angst-ridden teen cousin of
Stabby.
And boy, is he sad. Don't take our word for it. Squeeze his hand and let Tickle Me
Stabby
tell you himself with one of 13 pre-recorded emo sayings.
If life is so fair, why do roses have thorns? There is no God. You hear me? No God.
Why does he giggle and shake and stuff?
Oh, he will. Just pull a string.
Nobody understands what I'm going through, especially you.
See, my contention is nobody's special anymore. I'm not special. You're not special. We grew up and learned that life is not that much fun. You know what I mean?
And I countered that with, you're right. No, I
studied Eleanor Rigby. I was the only one I did of the, I did that one. I did the one by the Train of New Orleans. I did that one because we had to pick out a song every semester that you went into music appreciation. I just took that as one of my just fluff off things.
So you asked me, you said, what I think her problem is.
Yeah, what was, okay. I said, what was wrong with her?
She was definitely depressed, bipolar, possibly. She lived in a world of fantasy, non-reality. I mean, from what I get from the lyrics, and she's living in some kind of past.
I thought she was homeless. Eleanor Rigby picks up the rice at a church where the wedding has been. Why is she picking up rice? Lives in a dream, looks out the window, darning her socks at the nun. No, that's the priest.
She can't be houseless.
Hold
be
on
house-
a minute. The priest. I'm trying to think about this. No, that's the priest. I screwed up. Okay. Eleanor Rigby picks up the rice at a church where the wedding has been. Lives in a dream, waits by the window. I don't remember. Damn it. We're going to do
waits
it
by the window, keeping her
Father. That's Father McKenzie. Oh. Father
no, his teeth. No, she's the one.
Father McKenzie is darning his socks on the night while there's nobody there.
Nobody there. Right.
All right. Everybody stop talking for a minute. We're going to get this right.
Lyrics.com.
I think it's Eleanor Rigby picks up the rice at a church where wedding has been, lives in a dream.
Okay. Wait. I know this.
Fuck. We're done. We had our chance. It's over.
I look at all the lonely people. Picks up the rice in the church where a wedding has been. Lives in a dream, waits at the window, wearing the face that she keeps in a jar by the door.
Who is it for? I know
all the lonely people, baby.
Yeah, but I saw her as home. I cannot believe I just interrupted Eleanor Rigby.
I can't believe you're still talking.
Who is it for? All the lonely people. Where do they all come from? All the lonely people, where do they all belong? Father McKenzie, writing the words of
a sermon that no one will hear.
No one comes near. Look at him working, darning his socks in the night when there's nobody there. What does he care? All the lonely people, where do they all come from? All the lonely people, where do they all belong? I look at all the lonely people. I look at all the lonely people.
You have a chat people. Message from Lester Bartholomew Jones.
Eleanor Rigby died in the church and was buried along with her name. Nobody came. Father McKenzie wiping the dirt from his hands as he walks from the grave. No one was saved, all alone.
See, I've got to chat. It's the boss man.
God, is that a beautiful song.
Yeah. We'll see what
the well, bite me. I love it.
What we got here? The real Eleanor Rigby. Just like Debi said, because I'm sorry, He it says, "The real Eleanor Rigby lived in a lived a lonely life similar to that of the woman in the song. McCartney wrote the first verse by himself, and the Beatles finished the song in the music room of John Lennon's home in Kenwood. The song is often described as a lament for lonely people or a commentary on post-war life in Britain." No!
That sounds about right.
That was probably written by Paul McCartney. When I wish I could find those. I've got my papers here somewhere in a box. You know, I still have all my college papers and stuff.
Do you really?
Oh, yeah. Absolutely. I could show you some stuff right now. I've got a letter I wrote Victor 9 months after we got married. Right here in front of me.
Well,
Valerie got his voice. 42nd Street got Big Jimmy Walker. He's a pool shooting son of a gun. Now, Steve knows I'm not reading these lyrics.
Nope, you're getting a cajon. I'm buying you one.
I don't want a cajon. I'm a girl.
Well, if it's a pretty, rhythmic. Oh, there are a lot of beautiful women that play the cajon. Millions
of them. I am not going to sprawl out my legs and bang on that in front of people like that. I would do it in a bikini. Well, that'd be pretty hot.
And I'm thinking like naked.
Oh, man.
Naked.
I hope I can show you this picture that I found. I found an old picture. I hope it opens. It probably won't because it's stupid.
Yeah, it's really dumb.
Never mind. See, it just goes crazy. Stop.
I tried calling Dave Fiker today.
Why? What's wrong with
Nothing. Dude. I just want to tell him thanks for just being so supportive. He's such a nice guy. As soon as I put something out there, like a picture or a video or something, he's always the first to respond. And I really appreciate him. He's just a nice guy.
Dave is a cool guy. He just talks so much. Look, there's me and Heather. Look at me and Heather.
Yeah.
Look.
That's cool.
Look how scared Heather is.
You look like Magnum P.I. I got this baby.
I floored it. Because she's scared. She's with mom, not dad. I'm going, just shut the fuck up and sit here. I'm not going to kill you. Okay. And I went, she goes, mom!
So you guys who can't see this, there's a little tiny emblem of Texas, a little symbol of Texas with a number 7 on it. It's pretty cool. It's a great picture. That's perfect. A nice picture of you.
I just heard
God, you got enough tan? Good Lord. Start calling you Tyrone.
I'm darker than that now.
Jesus Christ.
Oh, look at all the lonely people.
You're not orange like Trump, though. You're like tan.
I'm pretty dark right now as it goes.
Okay, love.
Dr. B, what say you? Hold on just a second.
Sonny, you always
say Sonny, you need to do a little bit better. It says Eleanor Rigby picks up the rice at a church where a wedding has been.
No, it's not. Because she lives in a dream.
Steve, I'm going to have to. All right. Welcome, Dr. B, the smart one on the call. I love you.
Fuck you.
Yeah. Thank you.
Stay away from that other show. There are mean men over there. No, I'm joking.
Hello, Dr. Bristol. How are
you? Say hi to Steve, who doesn't know anything about the Beatles, Eleanor Rigby.
Hello, Steve. How are you doing today?
Doing good, buddy. Doing good. Thanks.
Dr. B, I found somebody that talks just like you, and he was talking English, but he was from another country. Where are your people from? I don't know. I'm originally from Japan. No, I'm joking, Angel. He loves when I do his voice.
I originally come from the port of Spain.
I
love his voice.
Where are your people? He has an amazing voice.
Yeah.
You say something, Dr. B.
Speak up when we say you sound good. You got to talk.
I'm serious. I heard it, and I said, I even said to Vic, that sounds just like Dr. B. And he goes, it does. It was.
Hello, Governor.
No, not that.
No, that sounded like a stroke. You're just stroking out right there.
Who was it?
It's supposed to be British sounding, but whatever.
Hey, stop. It was, what did I hear? Oh. The radio on the brave little toaster. Hey. You sound like the radio, because I was a stay-at-home mom. You sound like the radio on the animated film, The Brave Little Toaster.
The Brave Little Toaster.
Oh, it's an amazing, amazing, amazing story. It's crazy.
Toaster is hard to find.
Dr. B, did you ever see The Brave Little Toaster?
Hmm. I don't remember seeing the whole movie, but I've seen some parts of it.
You know, I used to think that one of the cutest things in the world was there was an old cartoon made in like the roaring 20s or something, and there's this little mouse that is drunk and he's singing with an electric shaver, and he's going, "How dry I am."
Yeah,
and the razor goes, it vibrates. And I thought that was the, and I've never been able to find it since I came on the internet.
Are you sure? I remember that. I don't remember very much about the cartoons.
Watch me nail it on the first. There it is. Look. And I've never been able to find that since I've been on the internet.
It's only taken 8 years. There it is.
It's a, he's drunk because he got into the alcohol. And he says, nobody knows. It's so cute. Look at the little shaver. Look. They're fixing to harmonize. Isn't he?
Interesting.
But when the kids had the, now that's not what I'm saying that you sound like, Dr. B. I was going off topic. But when I saw the brave little toaster with the kids, they always have it on in the background. It was amazing how he sounded like Dr. B. Listen. Oh, here is an, I've never heard this before. This is the radio tribute. This is you, Dr. B.
I always in it, I thought.
All right, we just got trolled. I got a lot of background. I got some background.
You've never sounded better.
I got some background hiss or something. Somebody's not muting when I play the audio.
I was muted.
Okay, must just be something else. Okay, here we go with the radio.
Well, that concludes our broadcast today, week. Actually, it concludes all future broadcasting of any sort. We'll sign off now with the suitable tune.
Mammy. Mammy, I'm coming. Oh, I hope I didn't take you away. Mammy, I'm coming. Oh, Lord.
And then the little tester dies, but man, I've got some bad hiss off of something. Where is that coming from? Can y'all hear that?
It
went away when Dr. B.
It went away.
Dr. B. broke it because that's what it does sometimes on your Skype. Just keep talking to us, Dr. B.
Yeah.
Oh, okay.
Box it out.
You know something? I could do some voice dubs in the future. Might even try to mimic the voice of the radio if I get a chance.
Wait a minute, let me do something. Okay, try that one more time. Do it again.
I could do voiceovers, but then again, my voice may not match that of the radio character.
I just took all the bass off of you. Okay, let me bring you back. I think you're gifted with a voice, and I think you need to step into your power. Especially in light of the recent petition, the anti-Brony petition, saying it's a hate group and you represent them. You are the top of the Brony nation. You know that, of course. You and, you know, who else. But I want to say to you right now, I'm so high, Steve. I'm having to focus. Focus. Shh. Where are you?
That's what I have to do.
Okay, hold on. Okay, I just hit my face. Okay. I think that if you're going to, you obviously have some sort of an interest in radio. Right?
Right.
He always goes, right. You need to step into this voice of yours, because I think that this is something that people would be all over. Your voice is so unique.
It is, brother.
Thanks. I was thinking about doing some commentary right after college, you know, to spread my opinions around. Yeah.
Oh, absolutely. You tell them when you want their opinion, you give it to them, okay?
Don't you think it would be cool if he auditioned for, like, a voiceover?
Yeah, I do.
For a show?
Absolutely.
Because nobody sounds like this guy. I mean, in a good way, Dr. Bristol.
We just cut him off. Just slap, you know, I am so sorry. Go back to what you're thinking about doing commentary on. I'm now going on mute, and so is Steve.
All right.
Well, ever since I did my studies, I was thinking about doing some commentary work because I have to convey opinions. Hey, Low Radio, how you doing, my friend? Oh, man, you're in trouble. Oh, you're about to sink.
Oh, they all got fucked up. It was horrible. They were trying to find the master, and the blankie got separated, and the master is a little boy. It's an amazing story, but then I'm on. Anyway, go ahead, sir. I'm sorry. And Bossman's fixing to call me to death in a second.
Mm-hmm. He's going to get you, girl.
He's going to. Sorry.
I'm just listening to you. You two are awesome right now. Talking about a toaster.
Yeah.
You know,
I'll admit, this film does have dark, scary, edgy, risque content because it's an independent feature.
He's on Wikipedia again. I love it. I love you. That's why I love you. That's why you're here. He always goes,
Dr. Google.
He goes, now once in the oh, fuck. Here we go.
You're in trouble, Deb.
He goes, once in the Vietnam War, there were 30,000 people across the nation. It was first brought out in Saigon by, it was so funny because I just knew this kid didn't have this stuff memorized. And I thought, that is, yes, sir.
I would like to ask Dr. B if he would be willing to do some voiceover work for me on my show.
He'll pay you, huh?
Sounds like a tough opportunity.
It might be. We'd see what we could. But there may be some stuff that I would like done. I think your voice is unique. Maybe we could figure out a way to make it fit.
You got to do this, Dr. B. You got to do this old, you know, Winchester Cathedral. You have got.
Yes. No, that's exactly what I'm thinking.
I'm serious. You have got this voice that is from the 20s or something. It's crazy what it is. It's amazing.
You've heard that song, right, Dr. B? That Winchester Cathedral?
He's going to hear it now, boss man.
There you go. Good.
This was recorded sometime in the 60s, but they were mimicking the 19 Roaring 20s bands.
Right.
Okay.
Right.
Listen to this, Dr. B. This is crazy.
And you could do this, pal.
Yeah, and not only that, and they sort of talk the songs. Back then, they didn't have records and stuff. Well, they did, but you were listening to a live band, and they would sing through a megaphone to call out to the people. You know, they would put when they did the megaphone, it caused their lips to kind of go like this, you know, one just.
Yes.
And they all kind of sounded like that. Well, this is a band from the 60s mimicking that sound, and it's amazing, Dr. B. And in the 20s, if you listen to any song from back in the 20s and the 30s, they would always play the entire song and then repeat the song, and that's when they would sing it. Every song I've ever heard.
Thank you. your bow. Winchester Cathedral, you're bringing me down. You stood and you watched as my baby left town.
That's you, my son.
Yeah, he
Dang,
totally,
that's
he,
awesome.
You could totally do that.
Do you hear what I'm talking about in this? Do you hear the... You could do a news report. In fact, when you did that show on the 1991 riots of L.A., you sounded like I was spellbound by your reading. It was spellbound. It was mind-bending to listen to this. He never misses a word. He never, nothing, Sonny, nothing. And he's reading cold copy off the internet. He's going in 1991, and it's the way he kind of bites his words that just
really
grabs your ear or something. It's crazy. I can't stand it.
Well, and it's unusual and it's different, and there may be some out there that don't like it, but that's their fucking problem. And for the most part, I think it would be it would be really entertaining, and it would be good to let you kind of dabble in that and kind of refine your hone your skills.
Yep. Agreed.
Absolutely, man. That's a great idea, Sonny. I like that a lot.
Oh, yeah.
And he was telling me, didn't you tell me? I'm so proud of your graduating thingy. I absolutely am so proud of that. That's crazy. That's life. That's real life. That's what you sink your teeth into, that kind of stuff.
Absolutely.
Congratulations,
man. I want to show y'all this. Yes, thank the fuck out of you. That's good. That's really good. Thank you for being a... Just don't fuck up after this.
He got into some heroin, man. He was over at that riot for the anti-brony thing. And no, I'm joking.
I'm joking, my dear.
I don't think anything like that would happen.
I'm listening. I'm sorry. Wow, I'm fucking up in front of Sonny. Go ahead.
Dr. B, so... How do you feel about now that you're graduating, unless you're going on to further that, how do you feel about the idea that you're not going to be going to school anymore here soon?
Well, I'm not too disappointed. For one thing, graduate school does seem pretty expensive after you reach your cap in financial aid.
You're right.
Hey, however, the foundation for learning didn't just end in that. In fact, I have the tools and the knowledge needed to continue learning throughout life.
There you go.
You can put together fucking sentence with these idiots that are like, hey man, I said I wanted fries with that man. I mean, there's some really dimwit. There's some thickies out there today, Dr. B.
Some sad
I'm not talking about
around.
Anybody that listens to this podcast. I'm talking about in the real world. I'll sit there. I mean, Sonny, you know what I'm talking about, okay?
Mm-hmm.
Oh, yeah. Sonny goes to concerts. He goes, I could bust that fucker right there. That's stealing over there. No.
No.
Sonny, there's some thickies out here today, you know?
Yep.
And I'm proud of you. They don't even go to... I shouldn't be talking so much, should I?
You're fine.
So what do you hope to do now, Dr. B? Now that this graduation is going to happen and all of that, what are you looking to do now?
Right after I finish off with two undergraduate degrees, I'm thinking about getting a job somewhere in Fayetteville in the next 2 or 3 years. That's at Western Arkansas, right toward
the
okay.
You just doxed yourself on the air.
Oh, sorry.
Can I show y'all some of this, him talking just real quick, Sonny, sir?
Sure.
Thank you. Okay, listen to this kid. Listen, and he's a kid. Listen to this kid reading. Listen, I'm just going to go to a random part.
Yeah. News cameras were on the scene to record the events as they happened. TV coverage of the riots was near continuous, starting with the beating of motorists at the intersection of Florence and Normandy, broadcast live by TV news pilot / reporter Bob Turk and his camera operator Marika Garrett.
He doesn't miss. I'd be going
Well, I've heard you read, and it's like listening to a story. So
No. I'll do a cold read against Dr. B right now, and I guarantee he'll kick my ass. What happened?
I'm sorry.
Okay. Listen to him.
I had a cable. Go listen.
But the way he does this, please don't let us hear your TT. The way he does this is mind bending. Here we go again. Listen to this, Sonny.
By virtue of their extensive coverage, mainstream TV stations provide a vivid, comprehensive, and valuable record of the violence occurring on the streets of L.A. And partly because of extensive media coverage of the L.A. riots, smaller but similar riots and other anti-police actions took place in other cities throughout the United States. I'm not necessarily talking about Ferguson, but I could see some similarities here. Law enforcement officer being acquitted, and then there's a riot caused by the community. And I mean the black community. I mean those who are really bad, not those who do good, like Dr. King or, say, Malcolm X or even Thomas Sowell. They won't put up with this kind of crap. The emergency broadcast system was also used during the rioting. Coverage came from the American Bee, which gave an extensive portrayal of the riot. Korean American media plus Korea itself, whether the North or the South. One of the most prominent sources for news about the coverage came from the Korea Times, a Korean American newspaper run entirely into American newspapers. So,
listen to how he reads that.
So you went off script for a minute to give your opinion in that commentary and then came back into character or reading your text, right?
That's right.
Yeah, okay. Cool.
It's the way, you know how nobody had the pause down better than, of course, my radio god, who is, and now for the rest of the story, what was his name, Sonny? I always forget everything. How could she forget if it was her radio god? Paul Harvey, right?
Yeah.
And there's something about the way Dr. B reads these sentences, and I cannot put my... Were you trained in this, Dr. B?
Well, partly through high school experience through East Lab Communications, and part of it has to do from experience, since I got involved in BTR in the first place.
And then he clicks mute. He goes, click. Okay, let's go back again and hear some of this. Listen to what he pitches his... He'll say this, and then he'll say that, and then this. I mean, you're cut from the cloth of radio, baby. I'm sorry. Here we go.
Not just the New York Times, Washington Post, and maybe Wall Street, the Wall Street Journal, yeah. The Korea Times helped to stabilize and balance the stories that erupted from, the 1992 riots, as well as give insight to the responses from the Korean-American victims. Man. This is really bad. That was really bad, folks. At that time, you can imagine, but there weren't any cell phones in that era.
Did you hear him say folks? I mean, who would say folks except a professional radio guy? Yeah, that's really bad, folks. I mean, I don't say
that's
folks.
Right.
I'm serious. I'm not.
Because that includes everybody. It's a smart way to do it. Yeah.
Well, okay, but it's just really freaking good is what it is. And I'm going to play a little bit more of this. I'm going to play another couple of 3 minutes.
Everybody carried them, and they just record the internet. No, you have cameras out there. Now, the writing ended, and it's, oh, my gosh. I mean, the significance of that is that it just emphasizes how much racism can cause damage to not only people, but also their properties as well. I mean, yes, European descent, African descent, those are two ethnicities that have been present most of the time in the 1992 riots. There were people of other backgrounds involved as well. Other articles...
There were people involved with other background as well. I just heard... See how he goes, well, and I would go on. I would say... there were other people involved in the background as well. I would go, well, I would drop it down. There's something about he's hooking us on these sentences is what it is. And I just think it's really, if you didn't, somebody didn't teach you that, that's natural born, just difference, talent, being different from me, like talking like this, you know. Anyway.
Yes. Yeah, there's absolutely a lively voice there.
Yeah.
He goes, yeah.
The
Watt riots of the 60s. Watts riots. Excuse me.
Did you just fuck up and run in front of me?
I did.
There were Watts riots in the 60s? What? Let's see. We'll ask Sonny. Sonny, what was the Watts riots? Were you there, or was that before or after high school? Or oh my God, I've never done that before.
That's funny.
I'm fucked.
No.
Yeah, I think. Trying to remember when that was.
Dr. B, beat him to it. Do it.
Watts was in the 70s. Watts riots.
No, it was in the 60s, wasn't it?
It might have been 60s.
Tell us about it, Dr. B.
I'm going to mute myself.
I want to hear him go. Oh, yeah. Are you talking about the Watts riots that occurred on August the 3rd?
Yeah.
I'm Bill Curtis.
Do it, Dr. B.
Okay. It'll be my pleasure. The Watts riots, sometimes referred to as the Watts Rebellion, took place in the Watts neighborhood of Los Angeles from August 11th to the 16th. 1965.
Yeah, so I was just a whippersnapper.
You were just a gleam in your daddy's eye. No.
Well, no, I'd already made it out the end of the pipe. I'm
end of the pipe.
Oh boy.
Yeah.
I wasn't born yet.
Now everyone knows just how much I needed that gal. That guy's blaming the cathedral for losing his chick. We'll go back to that.
I sent you the link of the statue of Eleanor Rigby. I sent you a link in Skype earlier.
It was wrong. Okay. Eleanor Rigby was homeless.
No, I sent you a link of the statue.
Statue? Really? What? They have an Eleanor Rigby statue?
Yeah, it's in your Skype.
It's in your Skype. Okay.
It's in your Skype.
Anytime somebody says you're this, I always go, no, you are. I do that in real life. It's a very bad habit. No, you need to hush. Okay. Eleanor Rigby is a song by the Beatles released. Hold on just a minute. We gotta finish with Dr. B and his talking thing. Wait a minute. But I'm gonna go back to that. And I want Dr. B to tell me what he thinks of Eleanor Rigby.
Oh, Eleanor Rigby.
Picks up the rice at a church where a wedding has been. Lives in a dream. Looks in the window. So she's not ever in anything. Eleanor Rigby died at a church and was buried along with her name. Nobody came. Father McKenzie wiping his hands from the grave as he walks through the door. Never mind. I'm not looking.
Watch, wiping the dirt from his hands as he walks away from the grave.
No, he walks from the grave. No one was saved. Okay. It's just a very deep song. I'm glad that you like that song, Steve. But I want to go back to this deal with Dr. B and his commentary. I think the kids like this need to be shouted from the rooftop. I mean, and that's what I do. Right?
Oh, he's great. Yeah, he's a great guy. I like this guy. Almost as much as Sonny. Sonny, how you doing, bud?
I'm doing good.
Oh, God.
All right.
Oh, by the way.
What? Yes, sir?
Don't
yell at Sonny like that. I'm sorry. Go ahead.
I don't remember what I was going to say because I've started...
Listen,
never mind.
Medicaid. Sir, I'm fucked. I'm fucked.
It's like the other citizens can get hurt too.
Yes.
Estimates of material losses vary between like $800 million and $1 billion. 3,600 fires were set, destroying 1,100 buildings, with fire calls coming once every minute. And of course, you can look at Time Magazine for our data from the time. It's like a primary source.
It's almost every sentence is a story within itself. You know,
That's a pretty good analogy.
You need to stop right now.
No, I'm saying good shit.
Fuck. It is. Maybe.
Oh. Yeah, he could tell you right now you look pretty. You'd be like, you better knock it off.
No, I didn't. Steve said that. That's not coming from me, sir. I'm telling you, not coming. Jacob. I just said Dr. B's real name. Oops.
Jacob.
I didn't hear that.
Jacob, I appreciate the analogy. Yes.
Jacob, on your avatar, you can see the background of the little crossboards. I can fix that for you if you want me to. Just say I'm backing out. I'm back. I'm on mute. Going on mute.
I got quiet. And then everybody was quiet. It was great. Hello?
Darren says that Dr. B sounds like a computer.
There are characteristics to where he stops, the way his pauses are so dramatic.
Yeah.
You know what I mean? But it's just awesome. I sound like an idiot.
Did you know when you're singing into a microphone, you whistle backwards? Jet goes, do that again. I did it today.
That's right.
Wait. Boy, he's really ringing my bell tonight, I'll tell you what. All right, just a little bit more of Dr. B and real talk with Dr. B. This is amazing. He did this the night after he was on our show, and I was talking, Mr. Minette Movie and I were talking about the race riots of 1992, and he was enthralled with it, and I like that. I mean, there are so many bad guys out there today. So many kids that just...
don't care.
I'm fixing to take you to the night-night box, Hank.
Uh-oh, Vic, run.
Can you hear him scratching? He's going. Unless he's going. Because.
Well, how would you like to be itching and not be able to scratch it?
Sorry, amen.
My love of my life. God, your nose was like a piece. He goes. Do it again. Listen. I grab his tongue when he licks my hand. He gives my hand.
I do that. I do that to my dog all the time.
I'm sorry, buddy. Okay, here we go. Here's a little bit more Dr. B.
I think it's Debbie Daly who said it was no longer about Rodney King. Causing all that crime just for the sake of committing that? Yeah, that's pretty bad. I thought the cops are supposed to be tougher than this. Yeah, pussy cops.
Woo!
Yeah, Daryl Lawrence. Well, the police chief who was... Let me see the name here. Daryl Gates. Yeah.
He's just bloviating now. He's not read. Thank you, Gunner.
Right.
Is this on your show?
Reading. Excuse me? No. Excuse me, you overtalked me? What was it? Asshole says what? No, I'm joking.
asshole said, is this on his show or yours?
You know what? I had a comic the other day I saw in a magazine that said, somebody said something like, it had a doctor, and the doctor goes, dead man says what? To the patient.
Dead man says what?
Wow.
And I thought, oh my God, that is so
mean. That's scary.
Yeah, it was about free stuff. No kidding. They just want free stuff. As though they're entitled. But they have some sort of mentality, like they want the government to provide everything for them, yet they're entitled to this and that because of the white man, or it's just because. I mean, you're talking about overgrown man children who want everything they want that their parents couldn't give them. I mean, if that's the reason why they do this, I'm not surprised that these are spoiled brats and, I'm not sure how they're raised. Oh, my gosh.
I remember telling Dr. B, it seemed to me when I was studying the race riots with Mr. Minette Movie, that it got to the point where it was, sit back down, that it became nothing but about the looting. It wasn't like they were out there going, you know, Rodney King, we will sing that he is, the people were very mean. Rodney King, they weren't rioting about Rodney King. All they were doing it was an excuse to go get a bunch of free stuff.
Right. And everybody you saw was not screaming into a megaphone trying to get some point across. They were busy trying to run with the next TV that they're taking to their house.
Yeah. They were opportunistic criminals. They were hoping for something big to happen where a lot of people would be out.
tell me what kind of person picks a topic to go and protest, and you get so caught up in your protest that you decide to burn down your own fucking neighborhood. I don't even understand.
Real talk. Real talk.
How you get there.
Yeah. I mean, Dr. B goes into this in detail because I've listened to this a couple of times. I mean, I think I'm going to use it for my, you know, I mean, it's just amazing to me the way he did this. And he goes into giving his point of view on this, but his point of view is so, I don't know if he, I can tell that he pre-thinks what he's going to say, because when you ask him a question, he doesn't just boom. You'll say, Dr. B, what do you think about Debbie's hair? He'll go, well, somebody really raised this kid right or something. I don't know what the fuck I'm talking about here, really, to be honest with you.
Well, I think you're right on. I think he was raised well. And I think he has one word that I always put out there, respect.
But you didn't have your dad around, did you?
Me?
No, I'm talking to Dr. B.
Oh, I'm sorry.
As of now, my dad's not with me. He died in 2004.
I gotcha.
And I see, that just made my heart hurt. So because that, either that or I'm going to have a coronary here in a minute. No, I'm joking. But the thing about it is that, so you weren't raised at the strong arm of, so that's the excuse that all these guys give. Well, I didn't have a dad, man, you know. I mean, you didn't really. I mean, because you're, I mean, I'm going to guess that you are 21?
No. 24.
25?
Oh, yeah, Steve, you're right. Damn. I'm 25.
Damn it.
Quarter of a century old.
Yeah, you're
old.
Oh,
you old dude, you.
But my point about that is there's a lot of 25-year-olds out there that do a lot of really bad and stupid stuff, and they say, well, his dad died at night in 2004. You know, because you were how old when your dad passed?
You could say I was like in middle school by the time.
How
it
old
happened.
Were you, Dr. B, when you this baby doll? Hold on, let's do the math. I've got my crayon. I've already got.
Oh, I knew that was coming.
Okay, in 2000.
I'm 13 years old.
13, 14.
Oh, that's a horrible age to lose your dad, dude.
Hell yeah.
Yeah.
So that excuse is all bullshit. Because look how you turned out. Unless you kill cats, and I don't know about this, right?
Yeah, I'm joking. Bad.
I'm joking. Say something. He's slow to respond to me. But
he's thinking. It wants to make sure when he says it, it sounds good.
I heard you take a breath. I heard you take a breath. He's got a really good voice. It's almost a sexy voice if you think about it. Sometimes where he goes, yeah, you know what I mean. He just kind of. He has got the vocal fry.
He has like, hey, now.
Vocal fry. Sonny, I've never heard. There's a vocal fry. See?
Oh my God. His voice would be perfect as a voiceover on a porno.
Yeah.
Wow. It would be absolutely the best.
I think he should read something. I think reading would there's people that would pay for you to read oral books. I mean, books orally or help. Help.
like books on tape.
I'm tagging in Sonny.
Yeah, audio.
Audio. With,
yeah. Yes.
Oral.
You know. The oral.
Yeah, just right after the porno comment. That's great.
Yeah.
She said oral.
Oh man, did you guys hear about Gilbert Gottfried reading 50 Shades of Grey?
I heard about that. What was that? What was it about?
Oh my gosh, it's like through some advertisement. For some sort of service that does audio recordings.
Stand by,
I've heard it.
Stand by,
I've
just
heard
one
all
moment.
Of
stand
Gilbert
by, stand by, just one moment. How freaking long has Vic been gone?
I don't know.
An hour.
Let's see. Wait a minute. He was obviously gone. I've been on the horn with you for 27, almost 28 minutes, and he was gone when I got on here. Or I think he was.
Dr. B, did Victor go get the Whataburger before you came? Yeah, it was before you came on.
It was before.
So how long have you been on, Dr. B?
Like, right now or way back?
Look at your Skype, Angel Love.
Look at your Skype and it'll say right under the name.
How long have you been on the call?
How long you've been on the call?
Oh, that's right. I'm seeing it now. 37 minutes and 36 seconds and counting.
So he's pushing an hour going about, four blocks.
Maybe they got it wrong and he went back and said, my wife will not be treated like this, you fuckers. Could have happened.
I'm betting no.
What are you getting to eat?
I'm hungry. I'm Whataburger.
You're getting Whataburger. Wow. Yes. Mm.
With A1 sauce on it. Yeah, how about that?
I got to say, if you're going to eat a hamburger, Whataburger's the one to eat, though, for
They're
sure.
They're real good. They are really good.
You've never had a Whataburger, Steve. They don't have them in
I lived in Arizona, young lady, for 2 years.
No.
I used to eat probably once a week.
Did you know that when the guy, Dave, Late Night with David Letterman?
Yes.
The first thing he said when he was going town, was it? No, it was Conan, I'm sorry. Conan did Conan live from town to town to town to town to town to town. When he came to Dallas, Heather begged me. It was in July of 2014. I remember that because it was the night of Goofy Bone and It was a night of my and Goofy Bone's debate. And she wanted to go downtown and see Conan live from Conan. When Conan comes on stage, the first thing he says is, welcome to Texas, the land of good-looking women and Whataburger. And I was so...
That's great.
Yeah, it was really fun. He was really cool, but that was Sonny when he goes to the... Yeah, no, it was when you were live in Dallas, you mullet. He became...
Yeah, he was live.
He became... Excuse me?
Yeah, I remember this. He was live. It was pretty cool. You played this years ago.
But what he did is he was, here's a little bit of it from, I'm not sure. I don't even know what I'm doing here. Hold on. It says Conan Dallas monologue. That's not
it. No, it was a live, thing. It was a big deal.
It was when he went town to town to town. Stop spinning, you idiot. I'm talking to my brain. It's the voices. Stop talking to me. Anyway. Forget that idea because something's wrong with my YouTube on Chrome.
I probably broke it. My cajon hit too hard. Sorry.
You know, and you like Chrome, right, Debbie?
Well, I prefer white gold, but yes, I use Chrome.
Yeah. No, but I...
That was quick.
Of course, you're using a Mac and I'm not, but I've just never liked Chrome. I just feel like Chrome is nothing but a big tracking machine disguised as a browser. Of course, they're probably all that.
I was going to say that, buddy. I think they're all the same route.
Yeah, you probably are.
Conan becomes a Texas deputy, I think is what I'm talking about, but it begins on that. I think when he says, hi, I'm in Texas, and he goes to one of them.
That's right.
He goes to Johnson County. Oh my God. You know, you're in my county now, boy. You know, and he becomes a deputy, and it is so funny because he goes to the range where they shoot the weapons. I mean, he goes to a simulator and he just shoots everybody in the whole thing. And the guy goes, wait a minute. You shot everybody. It's just funny, but I think this is it.
Did he really go do that in Johnson County?
Yeah. Oh yeah. The sheriff's on there.
Oh my God.
Do you know that sheriff, you cop?
How you doing?
No, you're in our county now, boy.
And then you hear ding.
You know what I'm saying?
It's
But he does. He goes to Johnson County and they deputize him. I'll show you on my screen if you want your Skype. And I think this is where he does it. Dr. B, you little white marshmallow. You win those little mini marshmallows. Okay, watch this, Sonny. Team Coco. Mm-hmm. Conan becomes a Texas deputy. And I think this is where he says, welcome to Dallas. Oh, please. I went and got a Whataburger. What? See, something's wrong with my computer. It won't play. It won't wait. See, it will too, Sonny.
I, for one, am a strong believer in small town justice. So here's what I did. I visited with the sheriff of Johnson County, which is located 50 miles south of Dallas, to see if I had what it takes to become a county deputy. Yeah. Take a look.
I have the rare privilege of standing here with Sheriff Bob Alford of Johnson County. Sheriff, good to see you.
Mr. O'Brien, my pleasure.
Okay, so are you going to deputize me today if I pass the test?
If you pass the test. Well, Conan, do you mind just a little background on yourself? Do you have a criminal record? Have you committed a felony?
I stole a wheelchair about 6 years ago.
Did you need transportation? Or
I just thought it would be funny. I thought it would be funny if the person came out and their wheelchair was gone. Looking back on it, it's not so funny.
At least you see the error of your ways, so that's a positive.
You're right. I will eventually stop doing it.
We're going to assign you to a big deputy. Of course, you're expected to step in there and help him if necessary.
Or can I just watch from the car?
Conan, you have got to get your hands dirty. You got to eat the beans, wear the jeans, get in there.
I'm sorry, say that again.
You got to eat the beans, wear the jeans,
wear the jeans.
Get in there with the guy.
Okay, the third part doesn't rhyme.
We have a training period you have to go through before you actually drive, and what we call the lead officer. Mm-hmm. Today, you're going to be the backup.
You're starting me at backup?
Yes.
Sheriff, all due respect, I'm a celebrity.
Yes, sir.
And I'm from Hollywood.
Yes, sir.
So why am I starting with backup?
You're a celebrity, and you're from Hollywood.
Yeah. Do I get to carry a gun?
Yes, sir. You're going to be carrying a 6-hour, .45 caliber, if you pass.
Okay. Oh, my God. Okay. Did that gun... I'm not very... I don't know a lot about...
Is that a real gun?
Decocked.
Oh, that's just... You're just decocking it.
Yes, sir.
I was decocked once.
No clip.
If I find that one, I'll kill her. So, Sheriff, this is the simulator.
Oh, there'll be different scenarios set up on the screen, so you have to make that call. Can I shoot this guy, or do I talk him down, or do let him go and catch him later?
Okay.
You and your partner are responding to a silent alarm at a local bank.
You stay here, and I'll check out inside. It's probably just another false alarm.
Okay. She's very attractive.
That was a civilian walking in there.
I don't know that. He looked like a maniac.
What happened? And you shot him in the back.
Well, shoot him in the back, you don't run any risks.
Red cover while I cut him.
Okay, I got him. Hey! Quiet!
Why didn't you shoot him?
Shoot him?
You shot an innocent civilian. This guy just whooped your partners, fixing to whoop you, and you're just standing there.
Well, first of all, he was wearing a T-shirt that said World Peace.
Oh, my God. This deputy, this sheriff, this is the actual sheriff. This is the head.
Yeah.
He's being serious with Conan, I think. He's taking this serious. I like that, you know?
Yeah, he is.
World Peace.
You stay out here, and I'll check out inside. It's
probably another false alarm. Was anything wrong with your reaction?
Two innocent people and one suspect.
Oh my
God. Man, that's overkill.
He started shooting a car that was driving by.
That's how they do it in Chicago.
Oh man.
The woman
and the guy
coming towards the bank.
I don't think there was anything left in the scene that you didn't shoot.
What did we do? We did get the bad guy.
We did. He was fleeing.
Yeah.
He was not a threat. When he turns and draws the gun, he's a threat.
Yeah.
You kill him.
Oh, you want me to wait till he shoots at me?
Sorry.
No, thank you.
Okay.
You know what I like to do? I like to take out the trash before it starts to stink.
What's a jury going to say?
Wow.
Jury. I won't get in front of a jury. Law doesn't touch me. Okay. Celebrities do not pay for their crimes.
Well.
Roll that list of celebrities that got away with it and go.
Fatty Arbuckle, Howard Hughes, Frank Sinatra, William Burroughs, Nick Nolte, Ted Kennedy, O.J. Simpson, Mick Jagger, Jimmy Page, Jim Morrison, Dennis Hopper, Roman Polanski, Snoop Dogg, Keanu Reeves, Jennifer Capriati, Christian Slater, Mickey Rourke, Hugh Grant, Little Kim, George Michael, P. Diddy, Tommy Lee, Carmen Electra, Dennis Rodman, Eminem, Robert Blake, Winona Ryder, Natasha Lynn,
Vanilla Ice, Marilyn Manson, Steve-O, R. Kelly, Kim Delaney, Yasmin Bleeth, Nick Nolte, oh, they already said that one, Joshua Jackson, Ozzy Osbourne, Michael Jackson, Edward Furlong, Rip Torn, Chris Tucker, Axl Rose, and on and on and on.
Yes, sir.
How many people in this town know kung fu? I mean, it seems like everyone we're running across is a kung fu master.
To be deputized. Hey, he made him laugh that time. The sheriff cracked up laughing when he said that. He's funny.
Well, given a gun and allowed to roam the streets.
I, Conan O'Brien, do solemnly swear that I will faithfully execute the duties of the office of deputy sheriff.
Of the state of Texas.
State of Texas.
Yes, sir.
Congratulations.
Thank you, Sarah. I won't let you down.
The way we do it down here, boys. Look at him. He's got his sheriff deputy self. He doesn't have his collar. He doesn't have his style on, though. Sonny, look, 635, 45, 30, and 35.
Ah, that's funny.
We know all of that. That goes to Houston. Yeah. That goes around Dallas. That goes east or west. And that also, I hate that one. I got lost on that one.
It goes north and south.
Shut up. It goes both ways. Well, then why is it 35 east north?
Well, there's a 35 east, which is the 35 that hooks up with 35 up north of us.
Okay, that's dumb.
And then there's
a
35W that splits off that catches
dumb.
Fort Worth.
That's dumb.
There's, I know.
No, I'm telling you, I had a guy on the phone. I got lost, and I got rescued by a wonderful 18-wheeler guy. And I said, he goes, stay right behind me, and I'll flash all my lights when you need to exit because it's stupid. It's 35 east, north, or 35 northwest, or 35. It's really, Sonny, you got to give me this now.
I absolutely agree. I know somebody that was coming to Texas from Oklahoma, I think it was, and they accidentally got the one that went off, and they're in Fort Worth, the next thing I heard, and they got 35W over there and ended up, 45 miles in Fort Worth.
Yeah, it's really dumb. Did you know that sometimes on Interstate 45, way in the middle of the night, that there's truckers that get in a convoy and go 120 miles an hour?
All right. No, I did not know that.
You should have known that, Sonny.
I know. Yeah. I like those boots he's standing on.
I know. Those cute. But I guess it wasn't he that said that, because some comedian or somebody said, when he came to Dallas at the Majestic Theater, the first thing he said was, "Hey, I'm glad to be in Texas, the home of Whataburger." Damn it!
Right. It was a different one then.
Who was that?
It was live. It was a live performance.
I know. Was it Roddy Carrington? He wouldn't have said that. Remember?
That sounds like something Rodney Carrington though would say.
No, it was definitely Conan O'Brien. Because I remember you saying the same exact thing, that Heather was all excited that he was coming to town. And it was a big deal here, too, because he was doing the tour.
Mm-hmm.
And he was funny as hell. He's a funny guy.
Yeah, he's great. Did y'all want to see part two? It's it's about a little under 4 minutes long.
Sure, why not?
Absolutely.
Part two of Conan Becomes a Texas Deputy. This is how we do it down here in the Big D, Long D. Okay. What did I just say?
I don't know.
You know, Damien, my partners don't tend to last too long. They play it fast and loose.
He's got a problem with his load, doesn't he? Should we go check it out?
Yeah.
We're going to write these guys up, or are you going to let them go?
Yeah, just let them go, kind of help them with the furniture.
So you don't think we need to shoot anybody?
I bet nothing ends up happening in the whole day, you know?
Sheriff, these mattress tags appear to be in order.
None appear to have been removed.
Hello,
up, ma'am?
Hello.
Good to see you. Everything okay here?
Everything's fine.
Anybody around here giving you any trouble?
Nope.
You haven't seen anything gone missing lately?
Actually, they did take some blades from me, their little box cutters.
This is important. Did you file a report?
Negative.
You did not.
It wasn't worth it.
When small blades go missing, it usually means something's up in this town.
Does it?
I'm telling you, something's happening in Alvarado. I just smell trouble.
Maybe you ought to go check and, I don't know. David's okay? They have some, I saw some old product in there before, like old candy bars, so be careful.
You think they're selling old candy bars?
Yeah, I think so. You better check.
Candy bars past expiration point?
But this was a couple months ago, so the trail's gotten colder. A
couple of months ago? Why didn't you report this? What is your name?
Sandy.
Okay, Sandy. All right, I like you, Sandy.
Okay, I like you too. What's your name?
My name's Conan.
Conan.
Nice to
okay,
meet
good
you.
Good name.
I want you to thank you. Served me well. Thank you so much.
Conan
it was nice.
The barbarian, you know?
I never heard that. All right, I'm going to head down.
A movie. Arnold Schwarzenegger. Big guy, buff guy, you know?
I'll be back.
No, I never
you
heard
of
that.
You better watch some on TV. You better go home and watch some TV.
I hate TV. Yeah. I hate the people on it. I better go.
There you go.
God bless.
Have a good one. You too.
Excuse me, ma'am. May I speak to you for just a second? You buy any chocolate in there? Any chocolate bars?
No.
Oh, yeah. They're open. You can come on in. Yes, it's open. Why are people just leaving when they see me? They see us and they leave. What does that tell you? Guilty.
Guilty of something.
Is this your store here, sir?
It is.
This is your consignment shop?
It is.
Can I ask you if you've seen any suspicious activity in the area?
Other than you guys seeming to run everybody out of David's, no.
Did you hear that some of the candy bars over at David's have expired? And box cutter blades are missing over the general store. I think they're linked. I'm telling you, Damien, there is something going on here. I've been a lawman for over 48 minutes. And I'm telling you, there's something
going on. Who's the guy next door?
His name is Sam.
You notice Sam? Been using some new box cutter blades recently? Eating any expired candy?
Not that I know of.
This thing's starting to come together. I'm starting to see the whole thing. My partner and I took a trip to Alvarado today, and there's a lot there that doesn't add up. First of all, we went to the Alvarado County store. We talked to a woman there, a very suspicious woman. With the Superman tattoo on her hand and Batman tattoo, she said that box cutter blades had gone missing. Is that correct?
Yes.
Box cutter blades. We then proceeded on her information over to David's Market, where we found out that there was expired chocolate. That led us across the street to a consignment shop led by a guy with a beard.
Brian.
Brian. The B means beard. Who's this Brian guy? Why don't we have any intel on him?
What about Sam?
What about Sam? I see a triangle, is what I see. And what's at the center of that triangle in that town square? A gazebo. There's a gazebo at the center of that town square. I think if you dig up that gazebo, you'll find $600,000 in cocaine.
Is he joking, for Christ's sake,
he's
man?
He's good. That's the talent that he has. Somebody pushed him, and look at him. You're no different than that. I mean, if you've got that talent, do it. That's a talent. That's a God-given gift right there. He's amazing that he can stay that calm. Shut up, Debi. Where is Biggie? Debi brought the water burger back. There's something wrong around
I think there. He's making your burger.
Corpus Christi, Bran.
What does that mean, Angel?
Yeah, Angel.
Oh, yeah. Corpus Christi. I think this is where that Whataburger was founded like 66 years
ago. Hold on, I gotta go on mute. I love this.
Yeah, Whataburger, as you know, is an American privately held regional fast food restaurant chain based in, it's actually San Antonio, Texas, that specializes in hamburgers. I mean, it was founded in Corpus Christi.
It's Christy, my love. Isn't it true that they were the first ones that did...
Hello, they're closed. I had to go to another Whataburger. You want my message?
No, I didn't. Thank you very much. I'm just starting to starve.
I texted you.
You're on the air, so be nice. All right, bye, Vic. Bye. How many of you guys out there would go, Look, the Whataburger's closed. Eat a sandwich, bitch. This thing's lined in gold, boys. What I'm telling y'all, just be nice to me.
It's lined in gold.
You know something? I think that there was... What was it about Whataburger, Sonny, back... I'm sure you were, second year college when they opened up? And they were different because we don't start until you get here. Was that their thing?
No. I don't even remember. I never even heard of that.
Dr. B, there was something about Whataburger that they claimed to be different in everything. It was like, we don't start until you get, or something like, maybe that was Burger.
No kidding. That might have been. I don't know.
There's definitely something about freshness. I remember going there, but I don't remember their slogan.
You've never had a Whataburger.
I swear on my mother I did.
Never. No, I'm joking.
On Mother's Day, I'm swearing this too. No, I really did. It was close to the house too. And they were
so
good.
Now,
they were
so
great.
Now McDonald's serves hamburgers that from meat that's not ever been frozen.
Oh, blow us, McDonald's.
Fresh meat, yeah. Like Wendy's has been doing it forever.
Safari is using an encrypted connection to YouTube. Encryption with a digital certificate keeps information private as it's sent to or from the website. I don't give a crap. I don't crap a give. I don't care. There's nobody trolling me on YouTube, is there, sir? Well, I just really think that I don't know what I think.
You think a lot.
I can tell you what I think. I think in Corpus Christi, Texas, there's a Whataburger that is over 6,000 square feet. Wow. That's what I know.
Are you kidding?
They really have one there. It's the largest Whataburger in the chain.
Did you know I put 82,000 pieces of something in my trash today on in my computer?
Wow, there you go.
Yeah.
There you go. I'm getting really tired of it.
How many?
82,000.
82,000 of what?
That's a good question.
Emails and stuff?
I don't know what it is, but there was 82,000 pieces of something in there. Because I remember going 80, and I haven't emptied it, and I'm wondering if that's what's causing my computer to laggy-waggy.
Yeah, once you dump all that, then you have to restart the computer, and it's like, oh, my God, all the catch files are gone. Everything's cleared out. It definitely helps.
Thank you, Steve.
Well, I'm going to bail. Look.
It says, preparing to empty the trash, items to delete 0. Okay, anyway, yeah. It said earlier there was 82,000. That's a lot of stuff.
How long did it take?
It hasn't even started. It's still preparing.
Oh, my gosh.
Anyway.
That's pretty cool.
Yeah. Did you say you had to go, Steve?
I do. I'm a little tired.
You're tired? No, I am always tired. So I've just decided I'm just always tired.
Well, there you go.
Yes, sir.
No, you need more sleep.
You need more sleep.
Oh, she told you.
Your body will let you know when you need more sleep.
I like that better. It's still preparing to empty the trash. I think this doll is talking about me. I'm fucking with y'all. Right, Goofy Bone, what's going on? What do you want? Shut up, Goofy. You know, Dr. B, can I tell him what you do sometimes? Oh, look. 78,000. Look, 78,000.
I saw that, yeah.
75,000, 74,000, 73, 72. Anyway, Dr.
Whatever it is, they're small because they're flying through. So it might be text, stuff like that. They're not images because images would take forever.
Yeah, this is true.
Who cares? Sorry.
I care, Grouchy Butt. You are grouchy.
No, I'm not grouchy.
You're
grouchy
and tired.
I thought I said something stupid. That's why I said, who cares?
You never say anything stupid. We're getting ready to do some new stuff around here. We're going to do a show where it's scripted and stuff, and you won't believe. I'm beating Steve to death. Like, half this is Steve. It's like, Steve, this is mine and Jewish producer's notes that we took, and it's really funny. We're going to do a thing called just some skits, Turner classic movies with Mr. Midnight movie, a skit where background music is played in Mr. Midnight movie, remembers an old movie and talks about one scene which is played out by others, with one exception, the scene is all wrong, but Mr. Midnight movie doesn't realize this. I told Beecher, no, Mr. Excuse me, I told JP, I said, I could do the scene from Gone with the Wind when she goes, Miss Scarlett, where are you going with the night out? The night air is setting in, and no, you don't have your shawl. And why didn't you ask them gentlemen to eat supper with us? You don't have more manners than a field hand. I'm going to speak to your ma about you. I said, I could say, Miss Scarlett, where are you going without any clothes on? And then you didn't even ask them boys to come and spend the night with you like you do all the other boys. I'm going to talk to your ma. You know, and then Mr. Midnight would go, that was Gone with the Wind. He doesn't, never mind. I'm just looking up. I'm becoming a comic.
This is cool. I'm reading what you had wrote. It's a lot of stuff. This is a lot of great ideas.
Awesome.
This was just one thing.
Yeah, I would love to do some of these.
Yeah,
I read a 30-second script for a PSA for United Way. That's pretty cool.
Do you remember it verbatim or no?
I forgot the verbatim. I mean, it's been a few years ago, so...
Movie producers from outer space with JP. Jewish producer is supposed to talk about Jewish movie producers, but instead he thinks they're all aliens. I came up with that idea. And then girls I could have married with JP on the couch with JP.
Good stuff.
I want to do the history of war with Sonny. You know? I really do. I want to have these things that are, it's more scripted and, hey, I got a happy movie. I got a happy
movie. I agree with that.
What about Hello, Debi with Mr. Midnight movie? Debi doesn't realize that her looks have faded and says, lady, like the old Jerry Lewis, but he goes, daily. And JP goes, it could be called if you only knew Debi then. He's an ad. Callers that make Debi mad. Let's see. Johnny T, Stuck in the Grease Days. Davy Jones, accept death with Davy, forcing him to realize. Because he never thinks he's dead, Steve.
He's not.
How to Dress for a Gay Wedding by Blaine. I don't know, just little bits and pieces like that. I think it'd be funny.
That'll be nice. That'll be good.
But I think so, too.
I want to start out with Previously on the Lunatic Fringe, and then everything that the person reads, it never happened. Previously on the Lunatic
That's
Fringe.
That's funny.
Debi realized at the age of, you know, just some crazy stuff, and go on and on just, and on.
Yeah, go out on the edge. Who cares? Have a good time with it.
Look, shut the fuck up, Dennis.
About getting a soundboard together?
Yeah, that's what I'm... Well, there's a lot of stuff. Davy Jones reviews, rate songs 1 to 10, tambourines, things that people do while stoned in Lowe's. That was Vic. Dating advice by Aunt B.
And I think, that's a good one.
You know?
That's good.
I think Victor knocked it out of the ballpark that night when he said that. That killed me. I laughed so hard. Me and Sonny were dying.
Oh, my God. That was
hysterical. Nice. But, I love that.
Because you know what? Mm-hmm. It's something that was like real. And yeah. I could certainly relate to it because I went and sat on a lawnmower out there one day for like 20 minutes.
Don't start it again, Sonny. Don't start it again.
Oh, my God.
Venture Walk. Sonny was really high on the show one night. And it was, I think it was Friday night, maybe. It was real recently. And he said something. And Venture comes walking in. He goes, hey, man, I can attest to that shit. He goes, I went into Lowe's the other night. And before I realized it, I've been there for 2 hours. When he left, I said, dinner's in about 20. He goes, okay. And I called him. I don't normally do that, but I called like about 2 hours later, and I go, Vic, what's going on? And I could hear they were going like, outside, garden, like, four, please, outside, lawn. So I knew he was hit Lowe's, and he goes, oh, wow, man. He said he'd looked at every screw in the screw aisle for some reason. Remember? Okay. And I said that me and Philip did that one night because we were working outside in their yard. Philip and I ran down to Lowe's. On the way, we, you know, it got high. When we get there, Philip and I spend over an hour and a half looking at bath things. Hey, bath, where they have sinks and stuff like that. And
right.
And then we started.
Countertop, like bathroom kind of sink tops, right? You're saying?
Yeah, they have unbelievable. They have them all set up like your little bathrooms that you go through. You know, what I mean?
Exactly.
The display. But
I wonder if somebody was so far gone they just actually sat down on the bathroom and used it.
You should have seen us looking at the carpet. I was going, Philip, look at this. He goes, oh my god. And then we were going, and then the phone rings, and I go, hello, and Heather goes, where the hell are y'all? And I went, what do you mean? And we honestly did not realize that we had been gone that long.
I'm sorry, but how funny is the idea of Sonny sitting in the middle of a department or a hardware store on a lawnmower?
Sonny should tell you about what happened when Lester went after eating a whole bunch of his homemade chili.
Oh, my God.
Wait, I'm eating. Oh. Never mind. Well, yeah, you can tell
I
us.
Did.
It's good. It's
well, no, fun. I just did a whole show about that, and then Lester experiences some real gastrointestinal problems as far away from the bathroom in a store the size of a super Walmart as you could possibly get. Yeah, it's it becomes pretty bad.
Yeah, Lester is a
yep. This is full of salad.
Oh, your food came.
Mm-hmm. It's got salad on. I hate that.
You did say on the way before you left, you said I don't want salad.
It's all salad-y. Kitty's in here. Let's ask Kitty if he likes Sonny. Kitty, you like Sonny?
Meow.
Shush, shush. You like Sonny, Kitty? Kitty, you like Sonny? He'll go meow. Kitty, you like Sonny? Where are you? Hank, don't be mean to brother. Hank. Well, he's under me now, but he's not talking.
Kitty. Is that Simon the cat?
No, it's Kitty. No, his name is Kitty. Hank, get out of the way. Come here, Kitty. Come here, Kitty. I'm trying to pick him up. Come here.
How long have you had Kitty?
Oh, here he is. He's in my lap. Hi, Kitty. Kitty, you want to go to say daddy? Huh?
How long have you had Kitty?
Hi, Kitty. Kitty. You want to go see daddy? Huh? You want to see daddy? He's right here in my lap. No? He's a gigantic furball. He's locked out of Steven's room. 7 years, I guess.
7 years. Yeah. See, I had a dog one time that I forgot to name, and we just called him Pup.
Yeah, his name's Kitty. His real name.
Wait a second, guys. There's an elephant in the room.
What?
How do you forget not to name your animal?
Well, this was years ago, back when I was the straight-laced law enforcement person, and okay. I was going to be gone for several months on an assignment. So I'd gotten this dog, and I had somebody going to come over and take care of the dog and everything. I just never did name him, and I never ever told the people that were going to come over and check on the dog. They didn't say, hey, what's the dog's name?
Right.
I didn't know. So I just called him Pup. You know, I came home after like 6 months on this assignment that I was on. And he was, I just decided to call him Pup, and that was the end of it.
There you go. Okay, well, that's how these things start.
Did you end up shooting?
Then I shot him.
You shot him? I knew that.
No.
That was
Because when you called him another name, he didn't come running.
That's right.
Steven said that Kitty should be named Kitty because that's all anybody ever calls him. I don't care. You don't ever go, Ralph.
That's right.
What do you say? You say, kitty, 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 kitty. Oh, well, there he
All right.
Hi, Bubba. What do you want, sweetie? Go see daddy? Huh? Ignore these lions around you. Get back, you crazy maniacs. They smell.
Oh, man. That was the dog I have. His name is also Bubba.
Really? Are you cereal?
Yeah. He's white with black spots and brown, you know, streaks on his face. And
what?
Of course.
It sounds like a zebra.
Sounds like you're making this part up.
It does sound like that. It's actually white. Yeah.
So he has brown spots and stripes on his face?
Not the thin stripes, but like more like paint splatter on him.
Oh, gotcha.
Good for him.
You want a bite, Gungan?
Yeah.
Easy, buddy. Watch Hank eat. Y'all be real quiet. Listen, you want a bite? Is so freaking cool. He's so badass. All right, boys, this has turned into a dog party. Get back. Back.
Shit. They're like, they're smart.
I know they're not. We're not going to listen to her.
Yeah. Like, she feeds us and thinks we're going to go away.
I didn't get a chocolate shake.
You didn't. You said you didn't want one.
I know, and I have nothing to drink.
So, I have a Dr. Pepper. I know you got Dr. Pepper in the fridge.
What kind of dog is your dog, Dr. Bristol?
Yeah, let's just say that he's kind of like, besides the appearance of brown spots, kind of look like a terrier. But he's a skinny dog, and he's really active. He goes, yeah, he wags his tail whenever he's happy. And has a narrow snout.
Dr. B, stop while you're ahead. He waxes his tail when he's happy. You're so cute. I would have answered that with what kind of dog. I would have gone, half border collie, part poodle. He has a snoot and he wags his tail.
Tail when he's happy.
It was so cute. Yeah, I hope you don't think I'm insulting you. I would never do that. Even if I hated your guts, I wouldn't say anything ugly to you.
Usually, it's the opposite. No. If Deb's having fun with you, she likes you.
If I'm poking at you, that's because you wouldn't be in this rat infested call. I mean, you're...
thank you.
No, I'm serious. These are some mean people on here sometime. Uh oh, Sonny went. I'm going out back.
No, I'm leaning over here to get a. I'm gonna. This one is beyond scrambled eggs.
Really.
Uh-huh.
I need that.
Yeah. I'll
order Colorado in a week, so I'll be able to get the best of the best.
Yeah. What'd you say, Dr. B?
Yeah. I was saying, I could, you know, if beyond scrambled AIDS, I could have ordered, like, AIDS Benedict Arnold.
That's funny. Why is that so fucking funny?
Because it's Dr. Bristol.
Oh, okay. Thank you.
Victor forgot two onion rings in my bag and he dropped his onion rings.
Hey, bonus.
How about that?
Victory is yours, Debi Taylor, if that's your real name.
No, it's not.
Well, I do know your real name. It's amazing.
What, Willie? Willie what?
Oh, Willie said, Debi seems to be talking to herself more often.
That's exactly. Really, Willie? I thought it was Willie.
It is Willie on the chat room 18 minutes ago.
Well, everybody needs a Willie in their life.
Sonny, how do you feel about everybody needing Willie in their life, Sonny?
I'm sorry.
Why? What'd you do?
I didn't hear what you said.
How do you feel about everybody needing Willie in their life?
I didn't know anybody needed him in their life. But if they do, then more power to them. I wasn't aware.
What I meant was, like, everybody needs that kind of kooky character in their life just to break the norm.
You think?
Yeah.
He definitely breaks things up.
On March 11th, I dedicated a song to Little Willie. But I never finished.
What was it?
Little Willie.
Little Willie, when they won't come.
Yeah, it's my sweet. Here it goes. I'm going to play this for y'all. It's real. I didn't finish it. I didn't finish it because I just thought, this is stupid. Kitty's in my lap. What is it, buddy?
Meow. The song goes, Willie or won't he?
Victor, remember, I'm the comedy, you the money. Look, he just walked out. He laughs. If any of y'all, Kitty is in my lap now. Should I pull his tail and make him meow? No. Come here, Kitty.
No.
Purr. Listen, he's going to purr. Purr into the microphone, Kitty. Steve, hush. Listen. Purr.
You hush.
Well, I've got the cat up here. And it's very...
Okay, stop it.
You're not getting any of my hamburger, Kitty. Kitty, no. Kitty, no. He's going to kill you, Hank. Move. He's a gigantic tomcat. He's solid black. Anyway, I made up this song. I was doing these one time. I did one, you know, for stabbing. I did one for these other people. And this one's kind of stupid. It's actually really dumb because what happened is when I recorded it, it was echoing back. And so the sound quality is horrible. So here we go. Terrible.
Oh, is there a break there?
No,
was that the end? That was really good. I thought your vocal was good on that.
Awesome.
Yeah. I really like that, Deb. You should redo that. It'd get better recording. You said was the audio levels weren't right.
No,
but the vocal sounded good.
I sang one to Sonny Bones when not my love monkey.
Aw, monkey.
He's mean. What did I? Oh, it was. It was. I sang one to Stabby to this song, and I did another one to Sonny. This is Stabby's that I did. I gotta find the words. I did this live on my show. No, I freestyled this. Listen. Stabby. Mm-hmm. Chat room warrior of my Spreaker show. Stabby. Every night you're there messing up, and I know you're the reason people leave. You're the one that will still deceive. Stabby one so bad, you make me sad. Steady, why so cruel? I'm your fool. so true. Fuck you. I changed the lyric just at the last minute. It's my responsibility to do that to the audience. The folks out there, is Dr. B.
The folks?
You called an audible.
I did call a frickin' audible.
You did call a friggin' audible.
I owned that shit.
It's yours now. What are you going to do with it?
I'm tired of y'all.
That's
right.
You tell them where you got that.
Don't even think you're going to go over there and look me up. Don't ignore that name. Don't look at that. Stop. Don't look at that. I'm telling you. Please.
I don't see it.
Good.
I closed my eyes.
Now, I did too.
You know something? My daughter did one night a long time ago. And it was the cutest thing in the world. Remember, Steve?
Oh, yeah. Delilah? I won't say it, no, but it's, yeah, I know what you're talking about. Playing my tees, right?
There's new listeners that haven't heard. Oh, they're all on private. That's why I just have to go up there to my panel, my control panel. Now, she did one, and it was the cutest thing. She didn't know she was being recorded. Is that mean?
It's cute.
It's mean.
It is mean.
You're mean. Okay.
it is mean.
White
teeth. She goes, "Hey there, Delilah." She's in the master bedroom. 61 views. What? Oh my god! That's on private.
Awesome.
And she sings this, and she doesn't. She does not know she's being recorded. That's the funny thing. Because I sit there. She is. She's real young. She's 17. Or 16 or 18. I don't know how old she is.
Hey, Delilah, what is it like in New York City? I'm 1,000 miles away, but girl, tonight you look so pretty. Yes, you do. Times Square can't shine as bright as you. I swear it's true. Hey there, Delilah, I don't worry about the distance. I'm not there if you get lost.
She still has that little girl look to her, you know, that innocence. You can tell. Mm-hmm. She's only, I think she's 17 in this, maybe, I don't know.
Heather, listen, close your eyes. Listen to my voice, it's my disguise. I'm by your side. Oh, it's what you do to me. What you do to me. Oh,
Dad came in to look at it.
What you do to me. Oh, it's what you do to me. What you do to me.
You have a chat message from Jewish producer.
Hey there, Delilah. I know times are getting hard, but just believe me, girl. Someday I'll pay the bills with
look
this
look at her eyes reading the lyrics.
We'll have the life we know we would. Hey there, Delilah, I've got so much love to say, and every simple song I wrote to you to take your breath away, I'd write it all.
My pumpkin head, look at her.
Oh, baby.
Oh, it's what you do to me.
She doesn't know she's being recorded.
Oh, it's what you
she would have
do.
Never done this.
Oh, it's what you do to me. Oh, it's what you do to me. 1,000 miles seem pretty far, but they've got planes and trains and cars. I'd walk to you if I had no other way. Our friends would all make fun of us, and we'll just laugh along because we know that none of them have felt this way. Delilah, I can promise you that by the time that we get through, the world will never ever be the same, and you're to blame.
She hears the music in her headphones, so she doesn't hear herself. So
exactly.
She's really staying on pitch, though, to be honest with
she
you.
She is.
Awesome.
Hey there, Delilah, you be good and don't you miss me.
Listen to me in the background. Listening, she hears me.
You know it's all because of you. We can do whatever we want to. Hey there, Delilah. Here's to you. This one's for you.
You go, pee. Oh, no.
I love that.
We're so stupid. Something's wrong with us.
It's true.
We're idiots. I just think she's precious.
Oh, man. I hope I'm not one.
You don't want to be... Wait a minute. Stop. You don't want to be precious?
Well, I mean, the word idiot carries a negative connotation for my...
Really? You know,
I've been bullied and I've been called an idiot before.
Hey, you tell anybody that calls you an idiot to come see me, okay? Me and Sonny will take care of them, right? What, Sonny? No?
All right.
All right.
I would help. I take pictures of the battery.
Yep. Sorry, I was muted. Yes.
What? I'm sorry. Did you say something? Are you still at Whataburger? Oh, no, you're home. Go ahead. What's going on? No, because Tyrone sings off key, no matter what he sings. Hmm. Why? Is he out there mowing the lawn again?
Oh, he's out there rolling something, though.
He wants to get a goat for the back lawn.
That way he won't mow it anymore.
You know, one of those Fred Flintstones? Y'all are so high. I hate y'all right now.
Me? I'm not. I'm completely straight as fuck, and I'm going to bed. So I love you guys.
I love you more. You're so sweet. Please, please stay in my life because you're so funny.
For now and forever, girl. From day one till forever.
I feel like a wedding song or something.
Yeah, it's getting a little hokey. But Tyrone.
Excuse me. What did you say?
The other guy in the
show. On the new show, Sonny. On the new show, he's going to have a bullhorn. So when he walks in the room. It's going to be going, I'd like to ask a question. He's going to actually have one. We've already ordered it.
Oh, that's great.
I thought that would be
cool. I love these new ideas. These new ideas, I can't wait to be part of.
I'm going to show you people in about a month what I'm capable of doing, because I'm getting ready to hang up the microphone maybe. And I am going to show you what I can do. Me and Drew. Oh, I just got a message from JP, my partner, my business partner.
Jewish partner producer.
Crime.
Yeah, JP says, what does free mean? Free what? Oh, wait a minute. Let's see. He said, I love you till I die. I told him. Okay, here we go. I did tickle me stabby. Holy shit, Debi. This is well thought out. I love you. Aw, Mr. Jewish producer. That's my business partner. He's the investor. No, I'm joking. He has wanted to produce a show for so long, and we've never done that. We did Wiretap Radio, which failed like a lead balloon. Steve, am I keeping you, sweet pea?
No, not at all. You're good.
Well,
I'm doing a final edit. I'm listening. I'm enjoying it.
Todd Morris, and he and Mr. Midnight Movie did a show called Wiretap Radio, and it went over like a lead balloon. It was horrible. We fought. We were fighting. We fought on the show. Now, see, that's what those people said was me breaking character.
You're allowed to do that. That means that you actually are into what you're saying.
You're allowed to. Anyway, anytime anybody comes at me with the word you, I always fire back.
Comes right back.
I come right back. I'm going
to
go,
you. You know, in radio, especially if you're going to like assign yourself a kind of a schedule to go by or whatever. A producer is as important as anybody on the show.
Yeah.
I can promise you that. A good producer can actually kill a show with no problem.
And here's what we're going to do. We are going to make it to where Steve and I tried. Remember the night we did the teddy bear? No, that was when I did it. That was a long time after we did teddy bear, that crazy thing. We did that in 2013. But anyway, also, as far as the payment goes, I want to ask you this, Sonny. If we get into a situation where we are getting funded one way or the other,
right.
I said that I believe you will be paid on content submitted, not performance of the content.
Correct.
Because
I agree.
You can have somebody that's just going, hey, man, what's going on? You know, what are we going to do? And just says, oh, that's cool. No, you bring content to it and add to it.
No, I agree. Yeah, absolutely you do. You have to.
And if we all start out at zero, you know, every payment cycle, whoever, boom, 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 brings content. Like the writers of Saturday Night Live probably make a lot more than those performers do. What would you think?
Sure.
Oh,
yeah, absolutely.
Awesome.
I don't know. I'm just thinking.
Now I'm thinking.
Now you're thinking. Yeah. That's good stuff, Steve. I love you to death. You're crazy. It's really surround. I mean, it's going to be a lot on Steve because Steve's playing a big part in this.
Well, I look forward to it.
Did you know when I sang That Night Health for Children on February the 13th?
Yes.
It was so mean. Somebody in the chat room said, you know, when I was young, they went through all this child abuse by saying Hell is for Children.
Oh my God.
It was so horrible. I had to stop myself. I said, I cannot believe I'm doing this. It was.
Well, even Pat Benatar and her husband caught a lot of shit for writing that song. Because in the beginning, the people believed that that's what they were saying. They were praising the devil, that Hell is for Children. And it was really about a story that she read in the magazine about this child that was abused and left in a closet.
Mm-mm.
And never fed and
mm-mm.
just beaten.
Mm-mm. Happy thoughts. Yeah, happy thoughts.
Okay.
I know what you're saying, Angel. Happy. Okay, I'm just real weird. You know me. I'll get all depressed and think, oh, what happened to her? You know, that's all I'm saying. I'm sorry.
I got you. Cool.
Happy, 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 happy.
Wow.
I am so hungry.
Not me. I am nice and satisfied.
I had pizza for dinner. We had Chicago pizza, the real pizza, the real stuff. Now I'm hungry. I would love for you guys to have like a real good pizza right now.
Mm.
Let me pick the restaurant and I will show you where the best pizza in the world is.
Did you know I had a dream last night that I met Sonny and Steve? I mean, Sonny and Guy Shea. Actually, it was Guy Shea mostly. Isn't that neat?
Cool. We talked about it the other show that we're all going to get together hopefully and
yeah.
Sit around and have a great conversation.
I absolutely. Certainly hope so. This should be that absolutely absolutely.
And listen, I'm going to be a lot closer. I'm going to be in Colorado, so for me to fly down from Colorado it's like a $80 flight each way.
Yeah, it's crazy.
That's nothing. Yeah.
Good stuff. Good stuff. Good stuff. I'm looking forward to it. Now, Sonny will say, she's just going to get nervous and say she's not going to go. No, that's not it at all. It's just you have to not be at a murder place because I don't particularly like murder.
Yeah, I'm opposed to that as well.
Yeah.
Murder just sounds so
dark.
Bad.
Sounds so permanent.
Something you don't, yeah, you don't,
so vital.
You don't come back from that. You know, it's like, bye. Yeah. Bye, yeah, bye, bye life, bye Whataburger. Bye, Sing Snap.
Condition.
Bye, Dr. Yeah. Bristol.
Bye, Sing Snap.
I can't believe ICP uses the word murder in its songs.
Hey, stop. Well, that's fighting words right there, buddy. Now, you're talking about Mr. Happy? Every time I murder, I feel happy, happy, happy. Murder, murder, murder you. I love the crap out of that song. I'm sorry. Sonny, stop clearing your throat. I'll shut up.
No. I'm good. I'm good.
What is it, Goofy? What? Shut up, Goofy.
Yeah.
Just give her a bone.
Hey, you know, oh, God, don't do it. Don't do it. You'll make me do it. What?
Oh, I was just repeating what Ghost said the other day. Yeah.
Oh, I know. Stop. You'd say nothing wrong. I have to show y'all something really funny if it'll play. Sonny, you will die when you hear this. I happen to think that I happen to think that this woman is one of the funniest things that has happened. Look.
I'm looking.
What does that even mean? What does that even mean? What is this? What? Oh, wow.
Hey, ladies, welcome to the first ever meeting of Women's Group. I know we're all very busy with carpools and birthday parties, but I think it's great that we're taking time to focus on ourselves and our goals.
Oh, I thought this was just an excuse to drink white wine in the afternoon.
Carol, you're bad.
Okay, I'll go first. My goal is to fall back in love with my husband. I want us to play, and I want to be wooed. Mm-hmm. Carol?
Okay, I guess, okay, I just want to, like, slow down, you know? I want to cook more, and I want to worry less.
Oh, yeah. I'll go. I want to start really considering the things I put in my body, and I want to take more photographs.
I'll go. This year, I would like to avenge the death of my father. He was taken from me 10 years ago, and now I plan to exact my revenge on the individuals who caused me this pain.
I want to learn how to set up my Kindle. Okay, that's great, everybody. Now let's pull out those vision boards that we all made. All right, now, Denise, would you like to go first?
Okay. These are some images that I find inspirational. These are fresh-cut peonies. This is Jennifer Hudson. This is yogurt. And this is an angel.
Oh. Okay, on mine. This is my dad, and this is me over his dead body screaming, "No!" This is really kind of before. This is the before image, and then this is the after.
Are you holding a human
head?
Wow. Yes, I am. This is the head of Raul Escorpion Diamante. He is the man that killed my father. This is the only known photo of him, and I hope to place red X's in his own blood over his eyes when I find him. And with the
Jesus.
Woman, I also have you.
That's awful. She is genius.
Very good job, PJ. I can tell you're very serious about your goals. So, who's next?
I wish I had gone before PJ, but this is mine. So, this is my dream kitchen. It's a Hampton style with a lot of like copper details. I like the airiness of it.
Mm-hmm. Okay. All right. Anyone else?
I got another one. I just kind of got into it. It made sense to me. This vision board is showing.
Sonny, look at the trailer right here. Look at the trailer. Look, she put dad under this one. Look, look. Now listen to what she's. Look at where she's been taking target practice. Watch.
El Scorpion's inner circle.
I'm sorry, why are you on there?
Oh, very astute. That's nice. I've been able to infiltrate his organization by gaining their trust mostly through sex. I consider my body a tool, not unlike a Swiss Army knife. And I love that sweater, by the way.
Oh, thank you. That's a very cute blazer.
Oh, yeah. I've had it for a while. I don't even know where I got it. Oh, yeah. And Taylor Loft.
Did you see her knives? She had knives.
Yes.
Okay. Now, did anyone and everyone bring an object that inspires them? Is that?
Yes. Okay. This is my own personal copy of Under the Tuscan Sun with Diane Lane. And I don't know. She just reminds me that we as women are like fine wines.
Oh. I'd love to borrow that from you. I love the message. Okay. I brought a box. Each time I've erased an individual as part of my journey, I've taken a trophy and put it in here. But I will warn you that the contents once seen cannot be unseen. So, you guys ready?
Oh, my.
Are you sure? Okay. It was mostly ears and one penis, so.
I know we all just met you, but it seems like a lot of your visioning is less about finding your best self and more about murder.
That's fair.
But, you know, Women's Group is about letting go of the past. So what I want to know is not who was PJ, but who is PJ?
That's a great question.
Watch your chest, Sonny. Watch your chest in a minute. Watch.
PJ likes to laugh. PJ can be a bit of a diva. PJ should probably give herself a break because she's a good woman.
Sonny, look at her chest.
PJ, I'm sorry, what's that red dot on your chest?
Does it follow me when I move?
Yeah.
Okay. How do you feel about gunfire in the home?
Well, I asked you to take off your shoes, so.
Okay. I'm gonna probably go. I want to thank you for lovely spread and having me in your home, and I'll see you at the next women's meeting.
That was on last night. She did.
Wow.
She did. She made fun of Spicer again. Did you hear her make fun of Spicer again last night?
No.
You missed it. She did the.
I didn't see it last night. Yeah.
She's crazy. I think she is. She is one of my freaking favorites. Did you see this lovely boy that I this that talk about the Comey firing?
No.
It's good stuff. She did one that was, she did, oh, here it is, Spicy Returns. No, that's 16 million. Hold on. No, wait.
Sean Spicer.
Stop. Spicy Returns. It was the new one that she did. She just did it last night, and she was so cute. I think this is it. Well, maybe I knew. This is it. Let me see. May 13th. Yeah. 5 million views, and it was released last night.
Wow.
See, they've gotten smart. They look at this idiot. They have decided to make money off of YouTube. 5 million views.
We now join the White House press briefing where Sarah Huckabee Sanders is filling in for Sean Spicer.
Making some serious money.
Okay, good morning, guys. It's an honor to be here today. For those of you who don't know me yet, my father is Mike Huckabee, and my mother is a big Southern hamburger. And yes, obviously, I'm hilarious like my daddy. Now, I'm filling in for Sean today. As you know, Sean is fulfilling his duty as an officer in the Naval Reserve, and that is why he cannot be here.
I'm pretty sure I can see him hiding in those bushes.
This is Sean Spicer getting trolled, basically, on a very high level. It is. It's somebody making a stupid video about him, and I don't see how he does this.
I believe that's a naval exercise. He's trying to blend in with his surroundings. Are there any more questions?
Yeah, I have a question. Can you just do this full time instead of him?
Yeah, I'd also like to ask that question because you are clearly articulate and charming, whereas Sean is bullish.
You know why you have to put your pants out? Because you're bone chugged lion in there. Pants lion. Yeah, move, move. When you lie all the time, your pants catch on fire. Liar, liar, pants on fire. That's why you put them out. That's right, Spicy's back, Sarah's out. Do this. First question, Michelin Man. Oh, I'm sorry, I meant Glenn.
Yes, some people are saying that based on President Trump's tweets that he is unhinged. Would you agree?
Oh, my God. Glenn, do I come to your job and slap the 7 or 8 hot dogs out of your mouth? Huh? You're really going to ask me that? This is offensive. If he's crazy, he's crazy like a fox with mental problems. Okay, next question.
Yes, I have a follow-up. Isn't it true that President Trump only fired James Comey to stop the FBI's investigation of him?
Shut up, Glenn.
I think the American people deserve to know.
Oh, you think that? You stink, Glenn. You stink.
Come on. I don't stink.
You stink bad.
I don't stink.
All right, let me just put this whole Russian thing to bed once and for all. Trump is innocent. How do we know? Because he told us so. Period.
Hearsay.
Hearsay. Lawyers to agree with him. And they're going to prove it with a certified letter, which you know is the truth because it costs an extra $2 to have it certified. And I got a tracking number right here, if you want to check it out. And it goes 855-46-1-1-8-5-6. Son of a... All right, wait, that's my bank routing number. No one used that. Okay, no one used it. You can't take money out of it. You want to put money in? Go ahead. Okay, next question.
Sean, you must know this Russia thing looks really bad.
Oh, my God.
Okay, there's no Russian thing. The only Russian thing here is my little dollies. Bring them out!
Have you ever seen Russian dolls? You know, you buy them when you go down in Mexico or anywhere you go. They're they I've got a set of Russian dolls from somewhere.
Gotta spell it out for you people. Okay, here's the deal. See if you can follow. Okay, first of all, here's Trump. Okay, he's the
biggest, I know what you're talking about. Yeah.
And he wasn't happy with the performance of the FBI director. Boom. This guy, Comey. Okay, because Comey wasn't being nice to our friend. Boom, Hillary. Okay, this dude. Wait, son of a... Okay, that's not... Don't look at him. Don't look at him. If you did this, Glenn, I swear to God, I'll rip you to shreds. So what actually happened is Trump conferred with his good, good, good friend. There you go, Steve Bannon.
Okay? Those busters.
And the decision to fire Comey was even confirmed by Trump's tiniest little buddy. Come on out, you little buddy. Jeff Sessions.
Jeff Sessions.
The next question.
Yeah, were you surprised that he fired Comey before he fired you?
Oh, God. Oh, that's like
Did
a
that answer your question? I honestly hope to God it killed her.
Sean, just be straight with us for once. What's really going on?
I am being straight with you. I'm telling you exactly what President Trump told me.
But what if he's lying to you?
He wouldn't do that. He's my friend.
If he's your friend, why does he make you come out here and humiliate yourself every day?
He doesn't make me. I like it. I get off on it.
If he's your friend, why is everyone saying he's about to fire you and replace you with Sarah?
Oh, bless your heart. This is the first time hearing of that.
I gotta find Trump. I'm going to New York. The press interview is over!
Oh, my God.
President Trump.
Now. He doesn't come here anymore.
Well, then where is he?
Mr. Trump, I need to talk to you. Have you ever told me to say things that aren't true?
Only since you started working here.
I don't think I can do this anymore, Mr. Trump.
Wow.
They're saying that you're going to replace me with Sarah.
Sean, come on. I would never do that. She doesn't have your special spice.
Look at the paintings. They look like children's drawings.
Yes.
Salt and pepper. A little bit of sugar.
No.
This is where it gets weird.
They nailed Trump on. Did you see?
Stop. You like when I do that,
through Trump's eyes? Did you see the one through Trump's eyes? That was horrible.
This is a horrible ending to this one. Watch the ending of this, though.
Well, they just kiss, and it's just kind of weird.
Oh, okay. You've seen it already.
It just tickles a little.
Yeah.
No, I'm married.
Sean, kiss me.
I can't. I have a wife. I took vows.
No, I'm famous. It's okay.
No, wait.
This is like the Godfather when you kiss me and no one ever sees me again.
Yes.
And then that's the end of it. But they did one that's called Through Trump's Eyes, I think it was, that somebody showed me. And I was like, that is amazingly horrible. And I don't see how anybody could. This is unbelievable. It's real short.
I'll be right back. I got to walk my doggies.
Oh, man. All right, buddy. Through, we probably won't play anyway because it's a piece of shit.
I'll mute myself and then I'll be back.
Huge, huge success. Fantastic. Victory, landslide, Fox News.
In fashion, big blue suits and long red ties sold out. Big success, pinnacle of elegance. Wow.
The failing New York Times, false reports. It's John Cena.
Look at his fucking hands.
That's how he sees it.
Thank you so much. Trump is bad. Trump is lies. Trump can't do anything.
Losers. Everyone hates you.
Look what's on his desk. Look where he's got medicine and there's wads of cash and champagne.
Loser.
Look at his hand shrunk. Look at his hand shrunk.
Yeah.
I love you, darling. I'm lucky woman. When I'm feeling beautiful for you, I am lucky woman.
Mike Pence here. Work job. Duty. Focus. Mm-hmm. Other people. Other people, not Trump. So many people.
So it's Kellyanne, your fan wants to meet you. Talk to your fan.
I voted for Trump. You will fix me. Thing you promised. Thing you promised. Can't wait for that thing you promised. Hollywood models are not your people. I am your people.
Come. Kellyanne will fix it. Mommy does everything. Mommy lives for you. Sleep now. Denny.
Wow, this got a little dark.
It's John Cena. That's how he sees himself.
Wait, that's pretty damn deep. I mean, that's dark and deep and strange all at the same time.
They're doing a lot of crazy stuff nowadays. They're really going crazy.
Shit.
They're gone nuts. It's
all SNL, man. SNL is making a killing off of Trump.
They're making a
this whole election.
They're making a killing off of YouTube is what they're making killing off of.
Oh, yeah, they're definitely, everything's getting millions of views.
Yeah,
right.
And they just did this. I mean, this was actually February, but the one I just showed you
that was last night. Yeah, right.
Yeah,
like 5 million views.
It's good stuff.
Wow.
Agreed.
Hey, I'm sorry, but I gotta hit the sack, guys.
Me
I really
too,
appreciate it.
I got two too.
Yeah.
Hey, I'll
all
be
right.
in bed by 3, which means if I can sleep till 9, that's 6 hours. But I slept today
there
for
you
a
go.
While. I know y'all love me sometimes.
You know I love you, but you're awesome.
I'm back.
We're saying
I'm going to get out of here.
All right. Thank you for calling in, boss man. What's up, Vic?
You bet. See y'all later.
All right, buddy. Have a good night, man.
What did you say, Vic?
Yeah.
Play that one by John Cena.
Okay. SNL. Did y'all see SNL John Cena? It was pretty fucking funny.
Because of that troll I did you did the other day.
I don't know if I can find it. I'll try. I don't know where it is. It'd be hard to find because it was unexpected. John Cena. Here it is. You gotta see this.
Pretty fucking funny. Good evening.
I'm John Cena! 49th floor!
Oh no, here we go. Here we go. Here we go.
How's it hanging? I'm John Cena!
Well, Lottie frickin' duh! We got ourselves a writer here!
Hey, Dad, I can't see real good. Is that John Cena? Who's this?
I'm Donald Jr., the brains.
I'm Ivanka, the beauty.
And I'm John Cena!
It's Friday, it's 10:30, it's time to party. I'm your excellent host, Wayne Campbell. With me, as always, is John Cena!
I'm Tony.
That's hard to know me.
I'm Sandy.
Oh, I like the beach in general.
And I'm
John Cena!
Guess what? I got a fever. And the only prescription is
John Cena!
Wow.
We've got a real barn burner on our hands. In the lead, we have
John Cena!
A message from Phil Leotardo.
No, you don't, because I can kick, stretch, and kick!
John Cena!
I'm Brian Fella!
No, you're not!
Hey, I'm sorry, I taught him how to say that. I thought you'd like it.
He's an imposter, because I'm
John Cena!
Well, that was an eventful church chat. Thanks for letting us chat it up with you. And right now, all I gotta say is,
live from New York, it's John Cena!
I just think that's so funny. I think that's funny stuff. All right, we're out of here, right, guys?
Well, yeah, no, I think it's up to you, young lady. But I'm gonna bail, and hopefully we'll do something this week. All right.
Yeah. Hello. I hope so. What are you talking about? I'll send a bunch of mercenaries out to cut off your protruding limbs if you don't show up here.
You know I'll be here.
All right. Bye. Stupid you.
All right, my
bye,
friend.
Bye, dumb Dr. Bristol.
Yeah, dumb Mr. Bristol. Good night, buddy.
I love y'all both so much, Dr. Bristol. You're the shit. I don't know how y'all talk in your lingo. What is it? You're like what?
Oh, you could probably consider me like, you could say I'm like that guy from Star Trek.
You're dope?
Oh, not say that. Was it Captain Kirk or sound like, I think I sound like him. So one of my buddies told me that from a BTR show called True Equestria Radio. Yeah, he saw
True
I had
Equestria
this
True Equestria Radio. I'm sorry. Nice. That's cute. I love y'all to death.
Yeah.
Me too.
Think about all our right. offers, all right? Especially Sonny's, because he's serious when he says that. He never says that stuff, okay?
Okay.
You're so right. sweet. And stay away from that other show. They're mean. All right, bye.
Don't get corrupted. You're a good soul.
It's just corrupt. It's not corrupted, but I'm an English major.
Well,
bye,
yeah,
bye,
well,
bye.
I'm not awake, so that's fine.
Kisses and hugs. Kisses and happy.
All right. Kisses and hugs. We'll talk soon. Bye-bye.
Kisses and hugs. We'll talk soon. Hang up, stupid Skype. That was Steve Rush, Dr. Bristol, and of course, the boss man known as Lester Bartholomew Jones. I am Debi with you on CNN Radio out of the BBC 8. And I will now close this train wreck of a show and go to beddy weddy. Well, go to bed anyway. And first I have to find this stupid song that I didn't even plan for this. This is really dumb. So here I am sitting here talking with nothing to do. We will close with our closing hymnal, which I do every day. But see, I'm real superstitious. And yes, the howling that you hear with Willie Nelson is Gunner. Gunner was howling. Gunner howls all the time outside when he's out there. He was out there by himself, and I came home through the front, not through the back, because if I come to the back, he knows me. I came to the front to find him howling, and I hit record on my phone and recorded him howling. So I thought that he would. So what I do is I just load up one in one of the racks, one of the decks, and one in the other deck, and I blend it together, and I know y'all could care less about that. But anyway. And, of course, the other voice you hear during the break of the song, the bridge, is my daughter. So this is our closing song. Thank you. Good night.
If you had not have fallen, then I would not have found you. Angel flying too close to the ground. And I patched up your broken wing. And hung around a while. Trying to keep your spirits up. Fever down. I knew someday that you would fly away. For love's the greatest healer to be found.